Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and lovers of drones everywhere, welcome to Thursday Night Live! Oh my goodness! Kelly Green's back in the house! Yeah, I do the sir. I do the punching bag. I do the whatever. So, Kelly, where you been? How you been? And what number plaid shirt is that you're wearing tonight?
This is brand new. I just got it at a store that's going out of business in my hometown for $11.
Wow. Do you ever shop at Goodwill?
Nope.
You don't?
Nope.
Are you too good for Goodwill, are you?
Not at all. Too much of a germaphobe.
Oh, that's right. Speaking of which, tonight we are going to play the germaphobe game. Coronavirus edition. Big, big prizes. And we've got a special 1 second song challenger for you tonight.
We're going germaphobe game and 1 second song tonight?
Yes, and it will feature a mystery guest that specifically requested to go head to head with you tonight.
Do I know this person, yes or no?
Also tonight, our guest is Zen Lee. This guy had his Skydio 2 jacked from him at gunpoint. It is a harrowing story. And he's a really nice guy, so we'll talk with him a little bit later. Just want to remind everybody that tonight's sponsors are RemotePilot101.com, LoomCube, GPC Custom Cases, Master Airscrew, FreewellGear.com, and of course, the Cadillac of processed meat, Pigeon Jerky, y'all! Copyright strike. All right. So, man, you know, all this talk of the FAA, NPRM, and the viruses and everything, it seems like 2020 has just been sucking so far.
Yeah, I would agree with that. I was kind of hoping for a big year. You know, 2019 was decent, but I was hoping for bigger and better in 2020. But I would agree with you, and you and I don't agree on much.
Right. Well, my philosophy is, you know, just try to have fun no matter what. I mean, if it gets horrible and there's zombies outside, I'll still be live streaming in here, still be coming up with content. This is a good distraction channel.
This is the only place, quite possibly in the world, where hundreds of people can gather and not have to worry about the coronavirus.
Yes, yes, this is a good place to gather for all your non-coronavirus needs. And I want to thank a couple of super chats that just came in a little while ago. Who did the first one? I think the first one was from Philip. Is it Philip Akoshat? Good evening, Ken. Short and sweet. Got to get back to work. Have a good show, and I'll catch the coronavirus version of Pound It. No. Yeah. Pound It. There you go. Thank you very much, Bulldozer. He says, hello, everyone. And once again, another one. $10 super chat from... Oh, no, I'm reading that twice. So anyway, thanks, Phil Kosha. Anyway, let's get into it. We got lots of news, lots of fun, lots of prizes tonight. And thank you, everybody, for sending in your viewer videos. Lots of them sent in. You can send yours, kenhearnupload@gmail.com. But right now, ladies and gentlemen, it's our favorite sponsor of all. They've been with us since the beginning. It is the Cadillac of processed meat, a Pigeon Jerky, everybody.
You'll enjoy Pigeon Jerky. Pigeon Jerky, the Cadillac of processed meats.
Yeah.
You'll enjoy Pigeon Jerky, Pigeon Jerky, and you'll give your family a treat. It's balanced nutrition to help them grow.
Yeah.
And it's full of fiber to make them go.
Here we go.
You'll enjoy Pigeon Jerky.
Pigeon Jerky, the Cadillac of processed meats.
Yeah. All right. Wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. And now let's get right into the news. That's not it.
Stop the music. It's time for news.
Ladies and gentlemen, everything you'd ever want to know about drones in the news. Let's head over to the newsroom with Jeff Sales. What's happening, Jeff?
Well, I got my special helper this evening. My son Matthew had his birthday recently.
Hey!
And one of the birthday requests that he had was to be able to introduce a new story on the show.
Okay. Do you want to show him first how to do a sponsorship?
Yes, I do. Are you ready for this?
Yeah.
All right. So tonight's drone news is brought to you by GPC Custom Drone Cases, providing you with the highest quality professional cases so your investment is always protected when it's not in the air. Custom cases also available by request. GPC, designed for life, be original, be blue. Use the discount code TNL10 for a 10% discount on all purchases at goprofessionalcases.com. Link in the description.
Very good. GPC, love you. Mean it. Now, how old is your offspring?
11.
How's that working out? You like 11 so far?
No. I want to be
15. Why do you want to be 15?
So I can be teen.
So you can be a teen. Oh, you don't want to drive? Do kids even want to drive anymore? They don't care about that.
You know,
my
daughter waited till she was 18 to get her license.
Why?
It seems like more and more kids are doing it these days. I have no idea. Maybe it's because they don't have a car. Maybe it's because the roads are scary. But, man, when we were 16, we couldn't wait. I mean, it was the day of our birthday. We were hitting that DMV for the test.
That's all I wanted to ever do is drive.
Yeah, right.
Well, now you got the internet, so, yeah, it just kind of takes
it's true.
Care. Yeah, why go places when you can see pictures of places?
Good point.
Yeah.
All right. So, is he going to do a new story?
So first in the news, I know that we're going to talk a little bit about DJI's releases, which, of course, there are multiple. The first one, obviously, is the one that's been making the news with DJI releasing these photographs of a drone, has Mavic stamped on it. A lot of questions and supposition as to whether or not this is a Mavic Mini Plus or a Mavic, replacement Mavic Pro or a Mavic 2. Mini or all sorts of crazy suppositions that they've got for this thing. Obviously, it's a bunch of photographs of something that DJI has made. Whether or not this is something that's going to come out, no telling. We've had photographs like this in the past. My personal favorite was the Black Phantom that was all sleek and had the custom look to it and stuff, and
right,
never heard of it ever again. So
are we growing immune to this kind of excitement, or are we still excited about DJI releases? Because they seem to be coming pretty fast lately.
Well, I mean, I get excited about DJI releases, but I guess it's the whole rumor mill and trying to be first to guess what they're doing. I'm just one of those people that is happy to wait until DJI comes out and says, hey, this is what we've got for you.
No, I think that's what makes it fun, trying to guess what they're doing, trying to decipher the little pictures or the renders or the, the leaks. I think that's what makes it exciting.
Yeah, I mean, just from this one, it looks like they have infrared downward-facing sensors and a light on it. So, and judging by the person's hand, it looks like what size would that be? Would that be bigger than a Mini?
Is that the same camera and gimbal that's on the Mini?
No.
Well, no. Yeah, it's definitely something that's different. And because of the size, this is definitely not going to be one of those, sub-sized drones like the Mavic Mini. This is going to be probably a heavier drone.
And people are talking about the controller a lot.
That's
kind of an unusual controller. Looks like they're putting the monitor back up top, maybe?
Yeah, it's the first Mavic controller that I've seen that didn't have a screen or something indicating, similar to the old Mavic style.
I think we're losing Matt's attention.
No,
he's like, I heard something over here. What's that?
He's new to this, so he's trying to understand. But you get to tell him about the next one, because instead of guessing whether or not DJI is releasing something,
yeah,
Matt, you get to tell them that DJI actually did release something.
Ooh!
Read what it says.
DJI releases Robo Master EP on March 9th as predicted?
Yep.
Oh!
So DJI released the Robo Master EP, which is the next version of their Robo Master
An innovative design loaded with advanced technologies.
So what's new and different about this one?
Okay, so this particular Rover Master has a bunch of additional features that can be added to it. The first one had, you know, the little gun and the camera on it and stuff like that, but the new one has arms and robotic arms and other attachments that can be put on it so that you can customize the drone. You can program it to do all sorts of different things. You can see they've got some with a flatbed on them, others with the ability to carry stuff. This again is the DJI putting a lot of investment into this robotics platform because there's a large, industry in over in Asia Pacific where they have competitions with these things. And it's just really fascinating to see how this particular product is maturing.
Yes,
and is the competition to see who can bore each other the quickest?
Well, for us adults, it might be a little bit boring, but for kids, I mean, wouldn't you love to have had one of those instead of a Teddy Ruxpin?
No, I want something that goes fast. Give me something that jumps and goes fast, like the Evel Knievel action figure and motorcycle we had when we were kids.
Oh, remember that thing? That was awesome. Well, let's ask a kid. Let's ask Matt, what do you think of the RoboMaster?
Good.
All right. And
they have 1,000 words.
I don't think I'm speaking out of turn here. I think it's all right with Jeff that I let him know. For your birthday, your dad is getting you one of these. So congratulations. He promises that he's going to get you one of these, or two if you want them. You know, one for each foot. It's going to be a lot of fun for you.
Here comes that bus that I just got 21. From.
Okay. Well, hey, man, happy birthday to you, buddy. Okay. Riveting.
So next in the news, we have, I guess, a follow-up on the FAA proposed drone rule. Obviously, we've gotten past the time that they're accepting any more comments on the proposed rule, and it goes on to the next stage. There were upwards of 52,000 or more comments that was on the NPR, and what was impressive was big companies like DJI and Google and others actually commented on their promoting the idea of keeping the hobbyist environment alive and not being not seeing what we do with our drones getting quashed, which was, to say, unique, I have to say. But there was a wide variety of comments on this thing. The interesting thing, though, for most people is what happens next. Because it's one thing for you to have the rule, but there is a very strict policy, a guide to the rulemaking process. You can look this up on the internet. It's prepared by the Office of the Federal Register, and it tells you the step-by-step process that the proposed rules have to go through. And it has to have, reviews not only by the FAA for all the public comments that are put in, which all of that stuff is recorded, all of that stuff is given credit.
Right.
The president gets to have a say on the final ruling. Congress gets to say on the final ruling. And what's interesting about this is that if there is enough feedback saying that the rule as proposed doesn't meet what they originally intended to accomplish,
yeah,
they can actually just quash it and not put out a rule.
Okay. Okay. Now, this is the NPRM that
one of the steps that's in here.
This is the NPRM that everybody's talking about, and that I went and I protested in Washington at the FAA. T-shirts available. Yeah. If you'd like to get these, Teespring offers these, and they're selling like hotcakes. The FAA headquarters there. So you could tell them exactly how you feel with the FA. Matt, put the fingers. Headphones. Cue. Now there's a link in the description of this video to the guide. There's a PDF if you want to go through it. But it will be slow to be implemented. So like this season, this spring, we can all pretty much just fly like we have been. You don't have to worry about it. I mean, of course, you have to wear a mask and respirator unless you want to become a zombie. But already people are seeing changes. Like, and I have not seen this message come up yet, but you say you have on your DJI app, on your product.
Yeah.
You've seen this coming up. Okay.
Yeah. When we went out to fly the last video that I shot, I went out and turned everything on, and I got that prompt telling me that there was this proposed rule, and that, and it gave me a links to go out and make a comment, etc. So DJI did a very good job trying to promote and drive people to go out and make sure that they responded to the FAA.
Okay.
Yeah.
And a super chat just went by. Rodney Boose. Oh, thank you. Hope everyone is doing well. My wife finally digs your show, Ken, and my last name is pronounced Boozy. That's right. Please put a pronunciation guide in if you have a wacky name. Boozy.
Okay.
And hello to Mrs. Boozy. Thank you for watching the show. Yeah.
Well, you can get that sound with the champagne glasses clinking, you know, for Boozy. So there you go.
Oh, no, I got a better one. Hold on. I got, yeah. Okay, here we go. Thank you, Mr. and Mrs. Boozy. Cheers. There you go.
Yeah. All right, so next in the news, our video that we shared with you guys last week with the skier having his drone smashed by the angry French skier.
Yes.
There was another video for this.
Well, let's watch the original first. And I say it's fake. Cover yours, man.
Is that you? Is that f***ing you? That's a f***ing joke. Sorry, you're joking.
We're just sorry, flying.
On you're joking.
Relax.
You know, no, I'm not f***ing relaxing.
Relax. Bring it down.
F***ing hell. Why? Why are you in the middle of the slope? Why would you do that? Why did you f***ing do that?
We're lowering it. We're putting it away.
Oi! Oi! F***ing shit! That was... Oi! F***ing prick! Stop!
You! You!
Wow.
You!
Whoa!
Wow. So, a few reasons why I think that's fake. Because if you're acting the fool, why would you post a video showing you acting the fool? Why would you... Who's the idiot in this equation? I mean, if it's real, and you're flying a drone that low in a ski slope, yes, you're an idiot. But I don't understand why anybody would film themselves enraged and post it like that.
I will preface my comment very seriously in this way. I am surprised every day on YouTube with what people will decide to post and share with the general public. So I'm not surprised that if some person was going down the ski slope and had this encounter and felt that they were completely justified in being an absolute tard and smashing somebody's drone, that, yeah, they probably didn't want to post it on the internet and be all proud and boast, etc.
Oh, okay.
But what was interesting was that there was another group of people that were down the slope that happened to be filming the same slope, just shooting they called it the piste, P-I-S-T-E. And this woman got another angle of the same thing.
Okay, so here that is.
Your drone. Qu'est-ce qu'il faut? Oh, putain. C'est ce qu'il mérite.
So why is that funny? That's not funny to us. Why is it funny to her, you think?
I probably just because of the shock value. I mean, it's more, they're like, more laughing at the actions of a person.
So you think she's uncomfortable with the whole thing? No, I don't understand. I don't understand French, but that didn't stop me from creating some subtitles. So here is what I am interpreting that she's saying. So here that is.
Your drone. Qu'est-ce qu'il faut? Oh, putain! C'est ce qu'il mérite!
Yeah. That's what I think she probably said.
Isn't it awesome in this technological age that we get different camera perspectives of just random scenes out in the community, out in the wild, out on a ski slope?
Yeah.
Well, with people walking around with these high definition, you know, camera phones that can film things almost as good as our old digital and 35 millimeter cameras, Yeah, I would hazard to guess you're going to see footage from all over the place. I'm and, surprised there wasn't more footage of this.
And Matt, what are your thoughts on this?
What do you think about somebody smashing a drone?
Nobody should smash a drone.
Yes. There yes, you go. I agree. A quick bunch of a burst of super chats just came in. So I want to thank Ray Bob and his antics with the first $20 super chat tonight. Thank you so much. Anyone else notice the two cable plugs on the new Mavic remote? Where would those be? I guess on the side, maybe. I did not notice that. Huh. All right. But thank you, Ray Bob, for the $20 super chat. And Wes Dunn, look what you done did, Wes Dunn. It's going to be a great year. Yes, that's what I say. It's already starting to warm up. And it was like 74 degrees here in Tennessee today as the train goes by. Can you hear it? Listen.
It just makes me want to get out on the open road. Yeah,
yeah, yeah. Yeah. And the Mo JEC with a 5-pounder. Corona pound. Yep. And he says, hey, from the UK, happy birthday to me. Same age as Ken, Norman Bland. Well, thank you. Happy birthday to you and Matt. And thanks, everybody in the UK, for staying up. I think it's, let's find out. Alexa, what time is it in London?
In London, it's 12:21 a.m.
Thank you guys for staying up late to watch.
Yeah.
What's next here, Jeff?
All right, so next in the news, we have the U.S. Army Research Laboratory has invented yet another new unmanned aerial system called GLUOS, which is a grenade-launched unmanned aerial system. So this particular device is a small capsule that is fired out of an M40 or 40-millimeter grenade launcher, and upon reaching a given altitude, the housing opens up, falls away, and it releases a drone from inside that then flies via parasail.
Oh, neat. And it's called the GLUOS?
Yeah, GLUOS.
I didn't hear it. What's it called?
GLUOS. GLUAS.
GLUOS. Okay.
Yeah. So this is the patent for this new technology. So hopefully we'll get some footage of this in the future as it develops.
You know what that is? It's a force multiplier! Indeed.
Well, always try to get you guys a force multiplier each.
Gotta
day.
Have those. Gotta have those.
Yeah. All right. So next we have the $1 million GoFly prize. This was a contest that was being held to devise or to get groups of people to come up with a groundbreaking personal flying device or a drone. And so they had this fly-off, and all of the people met at the Moffett Federal Airfield in California, and they were eligible for two $250,000 runner-up prizes, plus the $1 million grand prize.
Cool.
And of all the people that showed up, nobody could fly. None of them could meet any of the requirements necessary to be able to qualify for any of the prizes. And there were a lot of groups. There were more than 854 teams comprising 3,800 innovators from 103 different countries, and nobody's met the goal yet.
Well,
so
I mean,
look forward
to
seeing.
It's a pretty big prize. It's a good motivator and a great lesson for Matt. You know what they say, Matt? You know, if at first you don't succeed, give up. It's probably too hard.
Yes.
Yeah, there you go, buddy. Oh, and Rome Drone. I think we have a little lag with Matt. Rome Drone with a $3 super sticker.
Stickers, I like stickers. Yes, I do.
Yes, Matt.
Stickers, stickers, I like stickers.
Boy, that kid is—he's responsive. We gotta have him on every night.
Oh yeah.
Can we do take your kid to work day on the show one day?
No, this is, I have, you know, when Joseph had his birthday, he wanted to be on. And when Matthew had his birthday, he asked if he could be on. So
no, you could bring your kid. I'll bring one of my daughters. And Ken could do like an ad on Facebook soliciting for one of his kids that he knows are out there.
Oh, they're out there.
He's not quite. Not quite sure how to find them.
I'll get that knock on the door or email from 23andMe or whatever one day. Then I'll be able to take my kid to work. Now, do you have to bring them home again after?
You wouldn't, but Jeff and I would.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
They tend to frown on us when we don't do that. So. All right, so next in the news, this was an interesting story that I came across because apparently it was something that even I didn't know about. But apparently back in 2018, General Atomics Sky Guardian, which is a variant of the U.S. Reaper drone, did something that has not been repeated from the best I can tell. They flew one of these Reaper drones all the way across the Atlantic Ocean.
Oh, what is usually the range of these things?
They could stay aloft for a huge amount of time. And as for the range of them, they don't really broadcast that. You know, there is some secrecy to these.
Yeah.
But what's interesting is that this took off from Grand Forks, North Dakota, and flew to the RAF Fairford in Gloucestershire. Now, that's not coast to coast, per se. That's not like taking off from New York and landing in on the coast of England. That's actually getting pretty deep in the United States territory and flying pretty deep into the UK. So the journey through the UK civilian airspace was where the most ambitious part of this test had to happen, because they had a lot of groups that are against drones in the UK. And the idea of these anti-drone protesters finding out that this drone was going to be flying in as part of this transatlantic flight could have raised a lot of ire, I guess.
Yeah.
But this historic flight was kept pretty much quiet. It really wasn't documented. It was, I just recently found information about this myself, which I thought was fascinating.
Another force multiplier.
False multiplier.
Force multiplier.
All right, so next we have something that I thought was also very unique. Terra Drones in Indonesia has developed a drone that uses a ground-penetrating radar. Hmm. So this drone can actually fly over an area, and it can map the underground electricity tunnels and sewage tunnels and piping and everything else. And so they're using this drone to be able to fly over an area and map everything that's underneath it.
Wow.
That's really out there. I'd never thought of that idea.
Usually the ground penetrating radar needs to be actually rubbed on the ground. You know, you see these guys, whenever they go over to Kelly's house once in a while, just to make sure he hasn't put any more bodies in the backyard. It's usually on like a cart thing. And it's actually rubbed on the ground, but that's cool that it can hover and do the same thing.
This one can fly at different altitudes and different speeds to map different types of terrain and different textures of ground. So,
excellent.
Really fascinating stuff.
Yeah. Now, very quickly, does your birthday boy want to read what Super Chats just came in, starting with Pat Drone 11? Can he read? Is he that far along?
Yes.
I don't know.
You want to read that?
Yeah.
Hey, Matt, what is this animal?
Oh, hey, Matt. Pigeon. What is this animal? Oh, yes. Yeah, yeah.
It's a pigeon.
It looks like it might be a parrot or something.
It's a pigeon.
Is it a pigeon? Okay, we have pigeon confirmation. And that is a Canadian 279. Thank you so much for that super chat. And ladies and gentlemen, one from Jimmy J. What did he say, Matt?
Spring break greetings all. Hope yours is awesome.
Yeah. Nice.
Oh, another one.
Yeah. Oh, and what other one did we get?
Happy birthday, Matt. Cool that we share it, Norman.
Nice. And that is the Mo JEC, and that is a 5-pounder Corona Pound. All right. And one more from Adrian Mateo Drones, a $2 super sticker.
Sticker.
Yeah, we know.
No, there's one more in there.
Oh, there is?
Oh, yeah.
From Stephen Myers.
Hey.
You can try.
Anyone. see the FFA spy device on the new DJI remote.
I didn't know the FFA did that.
I didn't know the FAA had a spy device on the new DJI remote.
Yeah. FFA, FAA, who cares?
Yeah.
I tease because I love. And just once again, what bird was that?
There you go, Matt.
So, Matt, if you've got a pigeon and a parrot and maybe a cardinal and a robin and a bluebird, those are all grouped into one. What animal is that?
Right. How's he doing in school? Is he doing all right? Pretty good?
Oh, yeah, he's doing great in school. Yeah.
Yeah.
He's doing great in school.
Right.
Okay. This is his first time doing anything like this.
Yeah, no, I understand. He's out of his comfort zone. But, you know, back in our day, we might have been accused of sniffing the mimeograph.
Yeah. Did kids have more personality back then, or do they have more personality now?
I hate to say it, but I think a lot of kids today. Honestly, I think a lot of kids today are getting their personalities from their favorite online people. You know, they try to emulate their favorite online people or people on television. But we had to make our own.
They're so engaged with their social media and with their device that they haven't developed the interaction skills that we had. You know, that we developed every day of the week just outside playing with friends.
Right.
And they kind of hibernate.
Yeah, but we didn't have a choice in that. That was the lifestyle that we led. And, you know, the technology has changed to the point that aspect of life is kind of just gone by the wayside.
Yeah.
Matt, what
you
is
know?
Your...
And whether or not we'd ever see something like that again, just, you know, just depends on what technology comes out in the future.
True. Yep. Our social media was the CB radio. Remember that?
Yes. Oh,
yes.
CB radio. Matt, buddy, do you watch movies in your class? Does the teacher show movies sometimes?
No.
She doesn't. He doesn't. No. They don't. So you don't, no film strips, no overhead projectors?
She only listens to songs.
Okay, so unfortunately Matt will never know the joy of movie day. And when you'd sit in the class and you're watching something on history like the Hoover Dam. The Hoover Dam is just being built. Many, many thousands of pounds of concrete as we go. No idea what that is, do you, Matt? Okay.
Yeah, you will good never time. Have the experience of the wonderful projector.
And by the way, a couple more super chats. Let's breeze through them. Kelly.
Pat Drone 11. Is that Canadian 279?
I think so.
Matt, please say the word bird. Matt Mann, $10. Happy birthday, Matt, from another Matt. Anubis Arch, TJ Grady, $24.99.
Woo!
Matt, what flaps its wings and flies around? Jason Keller, $5. Happy birthday, Matt. Can you do me a favor and say bird? Alexander Jeffries, a $2 super sticker.
Wow.
Danielle, wait, whoa, whoa, whoa. Danielle X. Heron, $2. All I can afford on my alimony. Ken, is that yes or no? And I want the truth. Your ex-wife in the chat.
No, that's Drone Bum. He made a fake account.
Right.
No, that is no. She okay. Can't. She can't spell alimony. So Matt. what is the word everybody wants you to say?
Birdie.
Yeah.
Well, everybody's heard about the bird. Bird. The bird's a winner. Well, a bird.
Dance,
bird.
Matt.
Bird is a winner. Well, a bird. Bird. Well, a bird is a winner.
You just can't. You just can't.
No.
You just
no, he's got my genes, and all you people should be feeling bad about yourselves trying to make some 11-year-old kid say the word bird on the internet. Anyway.
All right.
Shame on all of you.
Shame.
All right. So next in the news, there is a place in Mexico called the Killing Fields. And obviously the thing that we want to take from this is that, you know, people coming across and going through Mexico, the drug cartels in the area are very, very dangerous. There's an area there that a lot of people have gone missing over the years, et cetera. And there's a group of mothers in Mexico that have been looking for missing kids. And they've decided, they've started using DJI Phantom drones to fly over these huge fields in Mexico to try to locate any signs or any evidence of where these missing people were.
That's great.
And it's sad that they have to do this, but it's good to know that the technology is there to kind of help them be able to find these things and gain closure.
Yeah, another good use of drone, man. I love it. Love hearing that.
Yeah. So the coronavirus, or excuse me, I'm sorry, we're supposed to not use that word anymore, the COVID, whatever the heck they want to call it this week.
Okay.
has you know, made its stake in the world. But one of the interesting things that we've had from this is being able to go back and look at some of the things that China did with the coronavirus. And what was really amazing was that in Shenzhen, there's 360 different drone manufacturers, all of which were making or supplying drones for the Chinese industrial complex and others to help in various ways try to control, mitigate, or enforce quarantines for this virus. Some of the ones, DJI obviously had a good portion of this. Micro Multicopter supplied more than 100 drones to be used in 11 different cities as part of their policing and transportation of supplies. They had dozens of drones that they supplied to all the various groups to be able to spray disinfectants. To warn people about areas that you know, a lot of people have gotten sick in, etc. So again, drones did their part in trying to help mitigate this.
That's great. And actually the number of cases are going down, or they have a hold on it in China right now.
Some countries have identified that they've reached the peak where they're starting to see less cases than they were. And the other thing that's interesting is the number of people that get the virus versus the number of people that are killed by the virus is still a very dramatically different number. In other words, there's not as many deaths per se as, you know, the people that are getting sick from it. So it shows that the medicines and the things that the hospitals are doing to help people that have this virus are working. You know,
yeah, so. But people are still freaking out, man. I mean, just recently found out that Tom Hanks and his wife in Australia have it, and they recently shut down the NBA season. What else, Kelly?
It looks like, and this is possibly one of the saddest days in the history of the nation, it looks like they're going to shut down professional wrestling for a while.
Oh, is that still going on? Anyway, so people... Peace out. People are really freaking out. And I found this out when I was talking with Greg Kunert yesterday. He's the one of the guys that, you know, besides Jeff, that helped keep this happening for you guys. And so yesterday, and I'm just getting over a cold. It's just a cold. And so I was doing this. So I was just going to blow my nose. And he goes, Ken, what are you blowing your nose with toilet paper for? People are killing each other over here. For toilet paper. So there's a TP shortage in Australia. And that brings us to the bonehead of the week.
Bonehead of the week.
Yeah. So Greg also sent me a video of people fighting over toilet paper in Australia. Enjoy this.
What?
Hey, stop! That's enough!
Are you
joking? Are you
fucking joking?
Get off this trolley now. How about that? Now, it may seem funny, and it kind of is, but imagine the panic you would have if you couldn't get a hold of toilet paper, something so innocuous, we take it for granted, right?
We went to a store last night. I live in a town called Murray, Kentucky. There's a little store there called Big Lots. It's kind of a discount store similar to Dollar General store. And we went there just to get some soap. We wanted some of that hand soap that we could just squirt our hands, wash our hands. Limit two. You can only buy two at a time. They've already set a limit on stuff like that in stores.
Yeah, man. That's crazy. I mean, people are really panicking. It's affected the airline industry. People will start hoarding things.
Yeah, here in Houston, we had the Houston Rodeo, which is a huge thing that they do every year. They have all these country western singers come and headline for like 2 weeks of just nonstop concerts, and they canceled everything as of yesterday. And this little fella here gets an extra week of spring break courtesy of the coronavirus because the school system has decided to let them stay out of school for an extra week.
Well, I hope we can get it under control and it doesn't really affect, because I mean, could have serious consequences on the economy, on the worldwide economy. Just be a bad thing all around.
Think about it this way, and I want to try to keep giving people some positive thoughts on this, because the media has put a spin on this that is just wickedly wrong, and there's a lot of people that have complained about it. So take in consideration countries that closed their borders, all right? The prime example that I'll give you is Russia, because in January, Russia was one of the first countries to close their borders. And of all of the people that had virus, they had 11 people that crossed the border into their country that had the virus. They were, you know, Soviet citizens that were returning to the country. All of them were quarantined. All of them were given medical treatment. All of them survived. They don't have any other cases in Russia. Zero. None. Period. And they haven't reported any new cases.
Yeah. Do we trust the borders?
We closed the borders here in the United States. We cut down the number of people that were coming in. Right? We have cases here, but they're not as grand as they are, say, in Europe.
Because we don't test as widely as some other countries. But we're not going to get into the geopolitical things about coronavirus when there's a cute little song.
My corona.
And I will remind everybody that we will play the germaphobe game, coronavirus edition. Kelly, your thoughts on this whole thing? You are the biggest germaphobe on the planet.
This is rough, man. I mean, I overwash my hands to begin with. Now I'm just peeling layers of skin off. I mean, it's scary. These are scary times.
I mean, it is. It's something we have to take seriously, and it's always good to wash your hands. And how about that lady from the CDC who's like, make sure that you wash your hands and don't touch your face. You did that? Remember that? Anyway, Jeff, thank you so much for the wonderful news, as usual. And Matt, buddy, happy birthday, my friend. Big 1-1. Yeah. And we'll give Matt the final word.
Say something.
He's going to look back at this later. One day he will look back at this. This will live on long after we're all dead. And he's an adult man. He'll be like, you know what? I was on the internet with my dad once. Let's check it out. And he's like. Anyway, Jeff, thanks so much, my friend.
Right. Thanks for stopping by. Now get out.
I got to love that Jeff Seal. Woo. Where's my placeholder?
We need to get caught up on our super chats, man.
Oh, yeah. Please.
Mike Garner, a.k.a. Light Show, $5.
Thank you so much.
The Mojack, $1.99 British pound. Should we pound it?
Oh, yeah. Let's coronavirus pound. There we go.
10-4, good buddy. Mojack is my ham radio call. Jimmy J, $2. Ken, don't ask Matt if he likes gladiator films.
That's an airplane reference.
Yep. Jack Johnson, $2. I mimic Ken Heron. I'm crazy.
Awesome. Thanks, Jack.
Stephen Myers, $1.99. Did you see the AK-47 adapter on the new DJI remote?
I did not see that. And by the way, I want to thank Stephen Myers because he's been taking a trip down memory lane on the channel. I go and I read all of the comments that people... He's watching videos from like 4 and 5 years ago. He's watching them all and commenting on them. And nice. You can do it too. There's a binge watch button. If you just click that, all the videos come up and you can watch the ones you want and it'll be awesome.
So, Joe Blaylock, $50 super chat. Matt's going to be mimicking you, Ken. My kids already do.
Holy cow. How much?
50.
Oh, man. Thanks so much, man. That is wonderful. Wow. Oh, my goodness. Thank you guys so much for supporting the channel. I really, really, really appreciate it.
And Jason Keller, $2. The coronavirus is just Y2K all over again. I don't know about that.
Mm. But thank you for the $2. Much appreciated. Now, I got a lot of great viewer videos. We're going to do a new thing today called the FPV MVP video. And it is astonishing. The winner of that gets FreeWell filters from FreeWellGear.com. Thank you so much. Before we go any further, we have to thank our good buddies at RemotePilot101.com. Do we not, Kelly?
Yes, we do. RemotePilot101.com. If you're flying around as a hobbyist, why not get licensed up and become a commercial drone pilot like myself and the world famous Ken Heron?
Yeah. Now, I have my second test coming up. And you just took your second test?
I did, yeah, a couple of months back. Thanks to RemotePilot101.com, I passed with flying colors.
Yeah, you have to take a test every 2 years if you want to be 14 CFR Part 107 certified in order to legally make money with your drone. If you use discount code HERON18, then you will knock that down to about $104.
Yeah, and it's good for life.
That's right. It's good for life. And with all of the changes coming up with the FAA, you're going to want to keep up to date on that. There's also a link in the description to Remote Pilot 101. Their YouTube page, and he very often they keep you up to date with something new comes out. There's a video about it. You don't even have to pay for it. Now, once you're a member of RemotePilot101.com, that is a great resource for you. If you have any questions at all, you can do a live chat. You can send them email, and they really do get back to you very quickly on that.
Jason Shepard is awesome, man. He's the best. And RemotePilot101.com is the best. Ken referred me to them a few years ago, and man, I'm so glad he did.
Yeah, and he wears two watches. Why?
Because he can.
Because he can. Because he knows what time it is, yo. RemotePilot101.com. Love you, mean it. Oh, no, Ray Bob, stop the show.
What?
Look what Ray Bob did. Now, see, normally Ray Bob's antics would be up here, but thanks to Wirecast, it's not. Thanks, Wirecast. This will be fixed next week. You will see the chat up there. I've been reluctant to update because I hate change. But so it's partially my fault, so I'll take that down. Ray Bob's antics, $75 super chat. Thanks, guys, for supporting Ken. If you want, check him out on Patreon. I recommend the Ray Bob level. Yeah, let me just go ahead and show everybody very quick. I'll bring up my Patreon page. And we're about to call our guest. There we go. Okay. So now we'll go over to the Patreon page. Hold on a second. Let me just put this here. I don't know if okay. Yeah, of course. Mm-hmm. Stand by. Kelly, feel free to talk or whatever. You know.
Oh, do you want me to tell a joke? I've got some classics
tonight so
great. That are going to blow you away.
Yeah, yeah.
Why aren't koalas actual bears?
Why?
Because they don't meet all the koalifications.
Oh, man, that's really bad.
And by bad, you mean good?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. No, apparently I can't show it. Anyway, there's a Ray Bob level on Patreon. This is all the
we'll
stuff
that
I usually have to do at the beginning of the show. Bibbidi bop. All right. So let's show one video before we get into bringing Zen Lee. Let me just go ahead and play a little bit of how he came to our attention. We're going to call him here in just a minute. Check this out.
Man, broad daylight. I don't have anything else to say. I'm going to upload this video to YouTube. And I don't know if there's any helpful information in it. And if I had been carrying a gun, I probably would have shot somebody or been shot myself. So carrying a gun, probably if I had a knife, probably same thing. If I'd cut one of them, he probably would have shot me. That's probably the only thing that kept him from shooting me was I kicked one in the nuts. And I don't think I landed any good shots. He was choking me out pretty good, but he couldn't choke me out.
So what is he talking about? Well, Zen Lee got his Scotty O2 and some other stuff stolen from him at gunpoint. This happened.
This is an amazing story.
It really is. And we'll talk to him in here just a minute. The Mo JEC with a 2-pounder, Corona Pound. There you go. Thank you so much. If we binge watch, does that earn you some money? Yeah, anytime you view the channel, that is money for the channel. So thank you. And Pete's Jeep Adventures with a, I think, was it? Canadian $10 super chat. Thank you. Glad to see you got rid of your coronavirus from last week. Yeah, I'm on the back end of it. Still a little stuffed up, but feeling a lot better than I did last week. And Jake Sloan, man. Hey, buddy. Sent you some more footage. And this time with an FPV crash of mine. Okay. Jake lives in Alaska, and he does a live stream on Wednesdays. And you know what his live stream's called?
No.
Wednesday Night Live from Alaska. Yeah, yeah.
So you stole his name, you dirty
That's it,
scoundrel.
Yeah. Wednesday Night Live from Alaska. So you just
Oh, you
on
missed
there.
You missed another tiny little super chat there from Mavic Mike for $99.
Oh my god. Mavic Mike. Mavic Mike is in the house, y'all. Mavic Mike. You know, I'm going to do something tonight. It's called Ken's Constructive Criticism. And, don't do this yet, but you can post links in the chat. I'm going to ask you to do that later. Don't do it now, because our moderators will knock them down. Won't you, moderators? But what I'm going to do is I'm going to open it up to anybody that wants a little bit of constructive criticism on their video. We'll go to your channel and check it out. We should probably do that right now from Mavic Mike. Let's see. Mavic Mike. Here's Kelly just dancing while we find that. Or
just kind of groove.
Or you could chit-chat about something. Doesn't matter. It's up to you. Okay, he's going to go with the dancing.
You know, I was excited about baseball season, but they pushed that back now, too.
Oh, Mavic Mike. Okay, I think this is it. Yeah. All right. I hope this is your channel. Is this it?
This is your channel.
Or it's another one. He's got 20 subscribers. Let's check it out. Let's check out his latest video, which he posted about
Mavic
a month
Mike.
Ago.
Mavic Mike.
Mavic Mike in the house. All right. So this is... Oh, I like big machines. There's no audio, but it's pretty cool, man. 4K. And he's going to put the dirt. Where do you think he's going to put it? Right
there in that truck.
Right in the truck. Man. And I bet that was done with the Mavic. What do you think?
Well, it ain't karma, Mike. So
yeah.
I guess you're probably
right. All right. One more video, and then we're going to call our first guest, Zen Lee. And don't forget, later on, we have a mystery challenger against Kelly for 1 second song.
So give me a hint as to who it is. Give me a hint. Drop one hint on me.
This person.
Yes.
Desperately wants to beat you. And they
are. Yes or no? Can I have three yes or no questions?
Yes.
is this person a Country Music Hall of Famer?
This is from Mark Dalton. He says, hey, Ken, great work on all your videos and TNL. Here's a video I made last December when I visited my brother in Arizona. There's quite a bit of climbing involved to get to this video, and all the plants in the region want to hurt you. Thankfully, the rattlesnakes were hibernating. Thanks, Mark Dalton. So this is Mark and his brother at the San Tan Mountains of Arizona. Enjoy this. Arizona is really beautiful. Have you ever been there?
Never have. The only western state I've been to is Texas.
They have a lot of cacti. Is it cacti or cactuses?
I think it's cacti.
Okay. So more than one cactus is cacti. Alexa, what is the plural of cactus?
The plural form of cactus is cacti.
It is!
Oh!
That's great! So they had to climb up there to stand up there and film, man. Wow.
I think there's a sky lift on the other side of the mountain.
Yeah, look at that. Thanks, guys. The Dalton brothers. Very much appreciated. All right. And some of you eagle-eye viewers may have noticed the Skydio in the background here.
Yeah, can we talk about that, or are we going to address this later?
No, let's talk about it.
Yeah, so you released a video this week testing the Skydio 2.
Yeah.
I would say it failed the test, or did Ken fail the Skydio by not following the directions or the warnings that come with it?
Well, the advertising for the Skydio says, sees everything in every direction. So I just assumed that it sees everything in every direction and would then avoid it. The advertising may be a little deceptive, but no, I didn't read the fine print. Apparently in the fine print, they have some caveats. Apparently it does see everything in every direction, but won't avoid everything every direction. But it was a very small wire. But so far, and I've contacted, I've been in touch with Skydio. They are reviewing the data, and they've been very nice about it.
The unfortunate thing is that's not your Skydio, correct?
No, but the guy, and he lives in New Zealand, so Skydio wouldn't ship directly to him. The original thing was he reached out to me and said, hey, can you ship it to me? I offered to ship it to him if he would let me play with it first. But of course, if Skydio doesn't replace it, I'll buy him a new one, of course.
You'll ship it to him as is if they don't replace it?
Yeah, I will ship all the pieces. No. No, I mean, if they don't, replace it, then I'll buy him a new one, and then this one still flies. It's just jacked up. That's all. I just don't want him to have a jacked up Skydio. Right. Speaking of Skydioses or Skydii, got a Skydio close call, a very similar situation to mine from Alex Philistine. He says, hey, Ken, this video is one of my first flights figuring out the Skydio 2. You can see where it loses tracking and tries to correct. It fixes itself, but comes pretty close to some wires just like yours did. So, here that is. And I particularly like this because he's driving a Mazda. The Skydio really is amazing. Does great tracking. Such an impressive drone. Tracking the car. Uh-oh.
No.
Avoided the trees. Woo!
Wow.
That was pretty close, wasn't it?
Yeah, so, I mean, like you said, it's an amazing device. It's revolutionary in what it can do because nothing else can do it as well as it can, but just don't do it around power lines, right? Simple as that.
Well, I mean, you never know what you're going to get. A teeny tiny tree branch, yeah. A random bird. I mean,
our buddy Billy Kyle, I guess it was like a reflection on water that kind of messed it up and sent it for a loop, right?
Yeah, and Skydio was very nice and replaced that for him. So we'll see. We'll see what happens.
Okay.
You know, either way, our friend in New Zealand will be getting a new Skydio as planned.
Gotcha.
So now here is Kelly with a joke as we bring in our guest, Zen Lee.
Have you heard all the talk about corduroy pillows?
No.
They're making lots of headlines.
That's pretty good.
Okay, thanks.
That's pretty good. I like that one. That's pretty
hey, you
good.
How long has it been since Samuel L. Jackson's told a joke?
Oh, I don't know. It's still doing that. Alexa, tell Samuel Jackson to get me a joke.
What's worse than a put down by a panda? The stink eye of the tiger.
I think yours was better, man. Yeah. All right, so we're waiting on Zen Lee. I think he's here. There he is. Welcome to the show, my friend.
Hey, guys.
Hey, man.
Enjoying the show.
All right. Hey, thanks for making time for us. Now, for those who don't know his story, basically, the reason we're having him on here, besides the fact that he's super good looking and has a great voice, like the rest of us, but you had an unfortunate, very interesting incident happen to you while you were out flying your Skydio 2. And where are you in the world, if you don't mind me asking? Where do you live? Where did this happen?
Las Vegas, Spring Valley.
Okay. Now let me your picture got huge. Let me fix it. Wirecast. I love you, Wirecast. You know I made it. Okay, there you go. All fixed. All right. Where was this again?
This is Las Vegas.
Las Vegas.
Nevada.
All right. And you usually go out and film for your channel by yourself?
Right. So I just got this Skydio maybe a month or so ago and have been going out and getting some really cool footage and posting it up on YouTube. And I absolutely, this is one of the best things I've ever bought, this drone. And then my electric unicycle behind me over here. Those are my two favorite tech items. Having a lot of fun. And it just kind of was an unfortunate day. Where he got jacked.
you know,
you can see I got new ones.
Yeah, people, you really don't. You kind of take your safety for granted, don't you? I mean, you're out there with you got your camera, you got all your tech stuff, you got thousands of dollars worth of stuff around. And if you're by yourself, you kind of leave yourself open to these kind of things. You never think it's going to happen, but it happened to you.
It was broad daylight, like 2 p.m. School's out. This place is right next to school.
Wow.
So kids are getting out of school, tons of people around, families playing with their kids. I mean, my guard was totally down. They really caught me at a moment of weakness, and I hope if anything I could pass off, you know, that as a person with this expensive tech, these drones, that we always need to keep our guard up and maybe have a buddy with you. Or
yeah, absolutely, that's a great advice. Now, that is the drone that they took. You recovered it, or?
No, unfortunately, I don't know who has the stolen drone. They're probably having a good time with it, hopefully, at least.
Okay, so.
Or the police or whoever.
Yeah,
has it.
Well, I don't want to get ahead of it. Take us back and just run us through very briefly what happened from the beginning.
Okay, so I'm in Spring Valley. I was going to meet up with a buddy who's also on an electric unicycle, which is this thing behind me.
Yep.
And it's a really fun device. You know, you could cruise around on it. And I met up with these, you know, I hand out my YouTube card. I was trying to get to 1,000 subs at the time. And I was like, hey guys, you know, there's kids around. I was like, try to get some more subs. Here's my card. You know, hit me up, Zen Lee. I'm almost to 1,000 subs. And they're like, oh, can we try your unicycle? And I was like, oh, you know, you can. It's my car right now. And I'm about to meet up with a buddy. And they're like, okay. And I just kind of went on, did my own thing. I went to a table and I was like, I'm going to put this drone up in the air, get some cool footage. This is a nice little park. And as I'm unboxing the drone, I connected the beacon and was about to get it up there. Maybe 5 more seconds, I would have had it up in the air. But I hear this gun cock.
Oh, my God.
And there's a gun pointed at me. And my first reaction, honestly, there was no fear or anything like that, because I thought it was a joke. I've been watching a lot of TikTok, and I thought it was some sort of TikTok joke. And I was like, oh, you kids making a TikTok? And then as soon as I said that, I got blindsided. This close fist knocked me down pretty good. And then I think one put me in a pretty good chokehold, but it wasn't strong enough to put me unconscious. I was able to fight off a little bit. I was in the Army for a bit and have a bit of a martial arts background. I think that helped me a little bit.
Yeah.
Kept them from putting me unconscious and delayed enough to get help. But so they're kind of gangbanging me, kicking me around. I have my armor on from my electric unicycle and my helmet. They kind of bashed in my helmet a bit. Got some good shots on my ribs. I don't know if they're broke, but they're still hurting even today. And I was able to kind of fend for myself. Going back to the crime scene, my stuff was scattered everywhere. So, I mean, I put up a decent fight. It wasn't like the Joker, you know, but it was pretty close. If you guys have seen the movie Joker, where he gets beat up by the kids, it was similar.
Right. And, but your video that talks about this, how long after the incident did you post that video? Because you were pretty emotional in that video.
Right. That was the same day, I think. I got home and I was like, I need to share this. I need to, I hope it was like helpful to some people to know that this can happen. I'm a pretty positive guy for the most stuff, and I just never thought anything like this would happen in broad daylight with so many people around. But it's something that we need to always be conscious of, I suppose, and make sure that you're protected in some way.
Right. Yes, Kelly.
Yeah. It's 2:00 in the afternoon, broad daylight, in a suburb of Las Vegas, Nevada, in a city park. And I'm sure there were people there. Did nobody try to help? Did people just gawk at you? I mean, in this day and age, a lot of people just get their phones out and start videoing what's going on. Did anybody capture footage? Or what was it like around you?
I was surprised myself. I was screaming, they got a gun. So I don't know if that, this is mostly students. There were a few adults around, but I think me screaming, they have a gun, maybe elicited this flight or fight response, and it was probably... I mean, you don't know. They probably didn't know what the full story was. They just know somebody has a gun and maybe took off. But there was one person there watching the whole time. I think she was autistic or something like that. She didn't even pull out her camera. She just kind of was watching the whole thing. And she turned out to be one of the witnesses. But I don't know how much information the police were able to get from her. But so after they finished with me, they grabbed the drone. The smart ones grabbed the stuff and just took off, you know, grabbed the drone, the car, whatever, or my phone, my iPad. What, a lot of tech stuff, my backpack.
What did they all get? What did they get of your stuff that you brought?
They got my Sky DO2, my beacon, extra battery. They got my electric unicycle, my Samsung S10 Plus, my iPad mini. I was carrying way too much tech stuff, but I'm just a tech guy. You know, I like my tech stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that's about it. It's about $3,000 worth of stuff.
Did you have any cameras running at the time to get footage of any of this?
I would have had the drone up. No, if I would have, man, I was a few seconds from having the drone up, and I don't know what that would have entailed, if they would have shot it or if that would have made them more aggressive, or I have no idea what the kind of a reaction that would have elicited, but it was a few seconds from being up in the air.
So you told the police, you went to the police, and what happened with that? Can you tell us? Is it ongoing? Did you get a resolution?
Yeah. So to finish the story, after they got done beating me up, there was two still left, and they wanted this electric unicycle, right? The other ones took all the easy stuff and went, but the other two wanted this wheel, and the bigger guy got on it and was trying to ride it, but it's not so easy to ride for anyone that's never been on one of these before. It's not an easy thing to ride.
Mm-hmm.
And his buddy was trying to assist him, who had the gun, and for whatever reason I knocked the big guy off. I kind of like football shouldered him off of it, but they immediately just jumped on me and started beating me again. So I was like, all right. I like grabbed onto his leg and we were kind of grappling a bit, and the one, his name was Dash, said, get away from him so I could shoot him. And I was like, hold on a second. So I just grabbed on tighter and pulled him in close so he wouldn't shoot at me and his buddy. And I was like, all right, guys, just take it. Okay, just take it. So they trying to get away on this electric unicycle. They're not going too fast. I see this girl who's watching the whole thing, and I go over to her, hey, call the police. And she like kind of pulls up her phone and like she didn't know what to do or something. I was like, 911. Finally got the police. I yelled to this police. I'm at Spring Valley Park. They're going this way. They're going north. I think it was north at the time. And I asked her if I could borrow her bike. And she's like, yes. Yeah. So I got on her bike, and it was a rickety bike. It's like, rick, 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 rick. I was like, I could run faster than this. But I chased them down to, like, this hill. I get to the hill, and they go up over the hill, across the street. Tons of traffic. Nobody, like, stopped. I was like, you know, they got a gun. Stop them. And I picked up a rock for whatever reason. Better than nothing, probably. And I hear them shout, he's got a rock. And, I forgot to mention, they fired up the gun in the air, which kind of maybe was spelled their doom in the end, because the police and I were able to find this casing later. It turned out to be a 9mm. Huh. They're running across the street. I run across. I drop her bike, stop in traffic, chasing after them with this rock. I would love to see the security footage of these, because we went through a shopping complex. There has to be cameras. I would love to see the footage of me chasing after them, put on some spy music or something. But I was yelling, Dash, just leave the wheel. You're not going to get away with the wheel. You guys aren't... Just leave the wheel. This is my car. And he did eventually leave the wheel, and I got to it, and I just collapsed. And that's when the police showed up, and yeah. I mean, that's the end of the incident there.
So do you have to go to court? What's left?
I got the police report yesterday. It looks like they got four of them. They're all one of them had the gun. It turned out to be a 9mm. I thought it was a fake gun, but it was a 9mm. I guess something I just kind of learned today was a lot of these people are printing, 3D printing guns. I don't know if it was the case with this gun, but it could have been, because it was kind of a... I've never seen a gun like that. So it could have very well been.
Hmm.
And looks like the police have four of them. I'm going to have to go down to court and testify against them. I don't even know if they got the right guys. I don't know.
So you have to do a lineup probably, right, at some point?
I'm not right. sure if it's going to even come to that. I think it's just going to be straight to court, and okay. That'll be the first time I see them. And it's kind of a weird system, to be honest with you. It's not as organized, or I don't know. It's not as proficient as I thought it would be, but maybe yeah.
It's not like
I've never been through this before.
See on television, but you know, you and you're laughing, and it seems awkwardly to try to keep an upbeat attitude, and you seem like your default is happy, but this has to affect you. I mean, there's probably a little bit of PTSD involved. This is something that's probably going to haunt you for a while. Do you agree? Or
right. I'm actually a disabled veteran with PTSD, and I've been through a lot worse than this, but absolutely, it's still with meditation and whatnot, I'm able to keep my mellow, keep my positive. And it's been people such as yourself that have really reached out and cheered me up and brought me up. I could have really went the opposite direction and just went into a dark place. Maybe you guys have been there before, where you always have this choice, and it's easier to, if you saw the movie Joker, that's the easiest thing to relate to. He didn't have a support group. He didn't have a community to fall back on, and he kind of went down the dark path. With me, I have you guys, and the EUC community has been phenomenal and has really taken care of me. I've gotten a job offer. I've gotten the Scotty O2 back. It's just been an amazing, overwhelming amount of support.
That's good.
And that's why I'm able to smile and stay positive.
That's awesome, man. That's awesome. Kelly, you look like you were wanting to say something.
Yeah, I was just wondering, just trying to picture this whole scene. Were they teenagers? Were they adults? Any idea on an age?
I'm looking at the police report. I think three of them were adults and one of them wasn't. But they all went to that school, I do believe. So either they had just turned 18 or were close. I'm not sure how that works, or if they're being tried as adults and they're not.
Did you have any kind of app or program, Facebook location, where people knew you were at a
That's
place?
That's funny you asked that. Yeah, I did. My buddy who I was meeting up, I always share my Facebook Live location. And he was able to chase them down. Well, he was looking for me. He wasn't chasing them down. He was right. looking for me. And but it went this 60-minute timer on the Facebook thing, and it went dead like maybe 5 minutes. They were quick to remove the SIM card too. And turns out they had like 15 phones and all kinds of stuff. So I wasn't the first person that they had done this to.
Yeah, this is something that, you know, the NPRM and all this remote ID. It worries a lot of people in the community, because they're wanting real-time information of where the pilot is, and there's going to be nefarious people that are going to want to take advantage of that. So that just cannot be allowed to happen. because incidents Absolutely. Like this will become more regular, unfortunately.
Conversely, I would be nice if I could somehow track my drone, the one that was stolen, or if there was way, but I get at the compromise of privacy, I guess that's the debate.
Right. Did you reach out to Skydio and see if they could maybe track it from on their end? If
I
anybody
did. And it, I don't think they could do anything. As the impression I got from the gentleman I talked to, they, I think because of like what you're saying, they don't have that ability yet, or hopefully they never do. I don't know. I'm torn on it. From this perspective, right now, I would love to be able to have that drone tracked down, and maybe they could catch another person, because it was 5 to 7 people, and if they only caught 4, there could be 2 that are still roaming around with this drone.
Well, I mean, if they're dumb enough to do this in the daylight in front of everybody, then they're dumb enough to register a stolen drone.
Sure.
You know?
Right.
Yeah. Kelly?
You know, with scenarios like this, you always play them back in your head over and over again. Anything you would have done differently looking back on it?
Yeah, to be honest, I didn't even want to go out that day. My energy wasn't too good. I didn't feel good. I wasn't my normal positive self. I was kind of going through a lot, and I went to an unknown territory that I hadn't been to by myself. If you're going to go to a new place with a lot of expensive stuff, and also the vibe wasn't too good there at this park. Usually the nicer parks here in Vegas, they have outlets where you can charge. I could charge my gear and my tech stuff. This place wasn't as classy as some of the other parks, and It definitely did have a different vibe. There's lots of homeless people, not the friendly type of homeless people around, I guess. They're right. More, I guess you could say, nefarious, or they just didn't look, I don't want to be rude, but they didn't look pleasant.
Yeah.
You know, and so there were bad vibes in this place, and it was just so many kids around. I got caught with my pants down, is I guess a way of putting it.
Right. And, you know, my default is always.
I really don't want anyone else to go through this.
Yeah, you seem to be the kind of a kindred spirit of myself. I just go, I give everybody the benefit of the doubt. I've been in hinky places before, and I just assume that most people are good. Probably not a good idea to do that, I guess, these days. It is best to have someone with you when you're going to be filming and having all this technology, and too much of a temptation for certain people, right?
Absolutely. These kids saw me with some nice stuff, and I was an easy target, and because I made myself easy target, they were willing to take a risk, even though the risk is probably wasn't worth it. Now looking back, they'll probably look back, it wasn't worth it to get a few $100 to go to prison for however long they're going to go to.
So did you get your wheel back, or did you have to?
I collapsed on it once. I was like, just leave it, you guys aren't going to get away. The two stragglers, I guess, that wanted to stay back and get this. And so I got my wheel, and that's a beautiful thing. I love this wheel. It's the best thing I've ever bought.
So of the stuff that you got taken from you, you've had to pay to replace the Skydio?
Skydio is hooking me up with this, but they didn't include the beacon. They're actually sold out of the beacons because of the coronavirus, I guess is what they were saying. I thought it was all American drone, but apparently, the beacon, maybe some of the parts come from China.
Ah.
And also the extra battery. But hey, I'm not complaining. Skydio was kind enough to replace the drone. I don't know. I don't think the warranty covers this kind of thing. So wow. They did it out of the kindness of their hearts.
That is great. That says a lot for the company. And absolutely. And thank you for your service for you know, what branch of the military were you in?
I was Army, 11 Bravo infantryman. I did one tour in Afghanistan, one tour in Iraq.
Awesome. Thanks for doing that, man.
Yeah, I appreciate you guys.
So there's a link in the description to Zen's channel. By the way, that's your given name, Zen Lee. That's really cool if it is.
Sure.
Okay, good. Good. We'll go with that. So there's a link in the description to his channel if you're into the wheels and all the technology and everything. Are you close to 1,000 subscribers now?
That video actually was my best video. Unfortunately, you think that I love some of my other videos. You know, I feel really passionate about filmmaking and cinematography, and this Skydio 2 is a amazing piece of tech, what it can do and the quality of the footage. And I was getting really creative with it, and I guess I'm going to get to creative with it again, but my best video was the one where I got robbed, and that put me up to 1,000 subs. So I guess that's another blessing in disguise.
Yeah, and you know, maybe people watching could subscribe to your channel, because there's as a creator, there's no better feeling than when you start getting a few more subscribers, right?
Absolutely. And being part of the community, the drone community, learning about your channel has been amazing. I liked your Skydio video, you know.
Well, thanks, man. So, not as bad as an experience as yours. But
and this is the first time watching your channel, and I'll be watching it again. You guys are amazing. I love the positive vibes.
Oh, awesome.
I love what you're doing for the community and everybody here.
Well, you got to be positive about it, because, I mean, it's just a fun thing, and the community is filled with such helpful and friendly and just kind people. And we appreciate you taking time to be on. Before I let you go, though, we do something with our guests every week called A Would You Ride It? And if this is your first time watching, usually what I do is I scour the interwebs for these, most of the time, homemade manned drones. Of course, they're not a drone. If they're manned, it's a kind of a misnomer. But these homemade contraptions that want to fly. And so I ask people in the chat, and I'm asking you and Kelly, as I show this video of this week's Would You Ride It? It's the EMAV from Concepto Millennia and Star 8 Green Technology. This is a group out of the Philippines, and that's this week's Would You Ride It?
How about cell phone in your pocket? No cell phone, okay?
That helmet will do a lot of good. So I always wonder if the person riding these things is the pilot themselves or if it's a buddy, and I can't answer that. But if it was a buddy, you'd have to really trust them, wouldn't you?
Absolutely.
Looks stable so far. What do you think, Zen? Would you ride it?
Yes, probably. I'm excited for the future, and I feel like this, whoever's making this, at least they're, you know.
Yeah.
Yes, I would do.
Okay. Yeah. I might ride it that high over water.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, but
over water.
Yeah, usually these amazing tests are over water. What are people in the chat saying? They're saying
a lot of no's in there, mixed with a few yeses here.
Yeah.
Jolly Roger Hobby says no way, I would not. JK Aerial Photography says I would ride it. Hell no way in all caps from Steven Drones. I think I'm getting a lot of yeah and hell yeah and I'm ins. Generally,
future's exciting.
Yeah, I think the yeses come from younger people that maybe don't understand physics all that well.
Sure.
You know,
I haven't met the friend yet that I would trust enough to control it if I'm sitting in the pilot seat there.
What about me?
I haven't met the friend yet that I would trust enough to control it.
Right in the heart. Right in the heart, man. Yeah, yeah, put it in full acro, do some flips with you.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I wouldn't ride it, of course. I know Kelly's answer because he has a family to live for. But Zen, you're like, yeah. Right?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Let's do it.
Awesome.
Do it right now.
Well, if you would, keep in touch and do send me some of your Skydio 2 video, and we'll feature it on the show in the future.
Absolutely.
Wonderful.
Ken, Kelly, you guys are awesome, man. And all of your chat, I've been reading your chat, you have some awesome followers. So
yeah, they're all wonderful. Thanks, man. Appreciate you being on. Take care, Zen. All right. He's out. Well, he is about the coolest guy ever.
Yeah, super cool guy. I subscribed while we were talking to him. I went to his YouTube channel, so he got another subscription there. But the link is in the chat if you want to subscribe to his channel. It's right there. He would be, and I'm just going to throw this out there, but he would be a good guest host when maybe I'm not available or Ashley's not available. He would be a terrific guest host on the channel.
Oh, I agree. And he's got great hair. I could not pull off hair like that.
Terrific hair.
If I grew out my hair, like, Would I look weird? I don't think I'd have the face for it.
You should try that just for fun.
Grow out my hair? I don't know if I could stand it. See, I might even grow a beard if it didn't have to go through the scraggly, itchy stage.
Your hair is so thick and luxurious. You should grow it out just to see what happens.
It really is, isn't it?
It really accentuates your fine porcelain skin.
Yeah, yeah. And my chiseled features.
Yes.
Good times. All right. So I want to remind everybody that I am doing a viewer video compilation coming up. I haven't done one in a while, so if you'd like to submit your video, you can. KenHeronUpload@gmail.com. Send me a streaming link, if you would. And that's KenHeronUpload@gmail.com. And the theme will be drone on drone. If you have footage of you filming another drone in the air from a drone, send it to me and I'll slap adapt it all together and put it on my channel at some point. Hmm. Yep. So, Kelly.
Yes.
We're about to play the germaphobe game, Coronavirus Edition. But first, would you like to see a close call video or a mini video?
Definitely the close call. The close call.
It's okay.
Kind of like watching a scary movie.
Isn't it? All right. So this is from our buddy Drone Bum, a.k.a. Danielle X. Heron. Hi, Ken. I was pulling away after chasing a boat and lost line of sight, then accidentally backed over the Parkway Bridge. Thankfully, no vehicles were coming. Feel free to throw me under a bus for my blunder. Lol, Drone Bum. So let's see how bad of a mistake this is from Drone Bum. Filming that boat. Backing up. Nice pull-away shot. Beautiful. Oh! Oh, my! Oh, dear! Oh, goodness! So he didn't... He didn't go over any cars, though. So you didn't break any rules except for the visual line of sight. And maybe if you had a visual observer, they could have told you. Or good thing you didn't hit that other pillar. So
I'm about to get a crystal sky with my Mavic 2 Pro and using my phone with a controller. That's the thing I hate the most about that. I just can't see it. It's just not bright enough. So I've got to go crystal sky. I feel like I'm flying blind most of the time.
Yeah, you know, I used to use the DJI goggles a lot in the daytime to block out the sun. But once I got the crystal sky, I mean, it's bigger and very bright. It's a very good monitor.
Is that what you use with your Mavic Mini?
No, you can't do that. I don't have it set up for that. And you can't use the goggles. Well, you can use the goggles, but it's a whole convoluted process. I use my phone. Yeah.
Okay.
But yeah, the crystal sky is a good deal for that, and you can use polarized sunglasses with it.
Ah,
you know,
so pricey.
Yeah, it is. It is kind of pricey. Yeah. So, Kelly.
Yes.
Being a germaphobe and living in the world of today.
It's a nightmare.
Yes.
General quarters, all hands man your battle stations, all hands man your battle stations.
Every day it's a fight. Every day there's more germs. And now with all this coronavirus stuff, good Lord, it must be just the worst for you.
Something new hit me yesterday. I was at a restaurant. Oh, two things at a restaurant.
Yeah.
Freaked me out. And I even texted you yesterday. I was at a Mexican restaurant where we live. Great food. It's just a terrific place. So I'm sitting in a booth with my family. Another couple comes in with their child, a daughter who looks like she's about 6 or 7 years old. They sit down in the booth right behind us. She starts coughing her head off incessantly. It's nonstop coughing. I said, family, eat as fast as you can, and we're out of here.
Oh, my gosh.
And we got the heck out.
Okay.
Because you can't take no chances right now. Then the second thing, I go to the bathroom. And this had never hit me before, but here's another problem I've got to deal with as a germaphobe.
Yeah.
You go in there and you wash your hands, and you know the automatic paper towel things that automatically bring the towels down. So I turn around to get my towel, and the towel's already hanging there, which means somebody's already touched the towel. Mm. So now I've got to figure out a way to tear that towel off so a fresh towel can come down, and it's just one thing after another.
I mean, this is the stuff that you normally think of, even pre-coronavirus. You, like in a restroom situation, if it doesn't have the hand dryer, you grab the towel and you save some for afterwards so you can open up the doorknob without touching it, right? You do all that stuff.
It never ends. And it's amplified now. It's just never ends.
Well, that makes for a great game. And right now, if you would like to win some fabulous prizes, say, Pick Me, Pick Me! As Kelly explains how the germaphobe game works.
So since this is the coronavirus edition of the germaphobe game, I'm not exactly sure what kind of situations Ken's going to place me in, but I'm sure they're going to be just outlandish. And he's going to give choices, and you've got to decide what choice I will make to hopefully get myself out of or end the germy situation that I'm in.
That's right. So I have five situations, five scenarios. Kelly has to make a choice. We're going to pick someone to play and just say, pick me, pick me. Pick someone to play for there, Kelly.
How about Bojangles? How about we go with Bojangles?
Bojangles. First name Bo, last name Jangles.
Got it. All right.
So if Bojangles can get the best out of five, then he wins. Fabulous prizes from freewellgear.com. We thank them very much for supplying the prizes. This is a beautiful set of filters that I have for my Osmo Action. These filters are very well made. They come in a magnetic case, and I use these all the time. These are ND filters. Fine selection. So we'll be playing with that, and let's hit the intro, my friends. All right, just five. And now, of course, the coronavirus, you know, COVID-19 it's serious. There's people that are actually getting sick, dying, but we're not laughing at them. We're laughing at Kelly's ridiculous germophobia. All right?
All right, so how's this going to work? You're going to read the situation, give the choices, and then the folks in the chat are going to have to guess what, or Bojangles in the chat's going to have to guess. Do I need to look for Bojangles?
Yeah, try to look for Bojangles, but we'll take a majority. We'll take a majority in the chat. All right?
All right. Get ready, Bojangles.
Here is the first scenario. I invite a guest on TNL to talk about how they contracted the coronavirus. Would Kelly co-host that night? It's just Skype. But the video could go viral.
I mean, could it ever?
Yeah. Oh, thank you. Speedy 99Q, Canadian $14 super sticker. And I think we missed some others.
Yeah, there's a bunch we can scroll back on here. Speedy 99Q, Canadian 279. Thanks for the great videos.
Thank you.
Keep going here. That's maybe as far as I can go. Ah, I'm sorry.
I apologize.
I know we missed a couple.
I know Geeks Vana did a $5 pound. So, thank you. So, once again, I invite someone to be on this show via Skype to talk about how they contracted full-blown coronavirus. Would Kelly co-host that night? What are people saying? No.
Everybody in the chat says no. Or the Bojangle says big negative.
Okay.
So,
do you agree?
If you were with us at the very beginning of the show, here's what I said. I said, this is the only place, quite possibly in the world, where hundreds of us can gather together tonight and be 100% coronavirus free.
Yeah.
So yes, I would host the show.
Okay, so he didn't get that one right.
No.
All right, that's fine, that's fine. And now we're realizing the limitations of your germophobia. All right. So here's the next scenario. 10 years from now, very important. 10 years from now, a decade. Kelly and his wife win an all-expense-paid cruise. After boarding, they discover that they are aboard the Grand Princess, the ship that 10 years ago had 21 confirmed cases of coronavirus. Do they stay or do they leave the ship? Try not to give hints, Kelly, as we read what people are saying in the chat. No, he won't. No way. Nope. Mark says we leave. No, Jolly Roger says he would leave. Most of the people are saying he's out of there. Do you see Mr. Bojangles anywhere? Ray Bob says he leaves the ship.
It's going so fast, I can't see.
It's all like, no, leave, big no way. So, Kelly?
Bojangles says, I'm going to go with, he doesn't like cruises, so no. I told my wife months ago, and I wish my wife was in the room with me because I would love for her to answer this question for me because it would be hilarious.
Mm-hmm.
There's absolutely no way I would get on that boat. I will probably never go on a cruise ever again because it's just like a big vessel full of germs. I mean, cruises.
But it's 10 years from now.
Don't care. I would never go on a cruise. I don't care if it's that ship or not. Okay. I would never go on one again. There have been so many cases of just things going horribly wrong.
All right. So
thermally wrong.
Okay, so Bojangles, you got that one right. One right, one wrong. All right. Wow. here is the next scenario. The CDC finally finds a coronavirus vaccination. A glass of expired milk. Does Kelly inoculate himself or just take his chances? This might be my favorite. What do people say?
You swerved me on that one.
Yeah, I did. I know you, pal. All right, so the cure is a glass of expired milk. Kelly will not, for the record, drink expired milk even an hour after it expires. He would die first.
Rational answer here, so we'll see if anybody.
He would die first. He drinks it. Law perfect, Ken. No, yes. Do you see
Bojangles says, spoiled milk only once, though. Yes, he would.
Okay. Wow, there's people like, no way! Ray Bob says, no, he wouldn't. What would you do, Kelly?
So here's the deal.
Yeah.
The good heavily, heavily outweighs the bad with this one.
Yeah, but you don't have the coronavirus.
It's a vaccination, right?
Oh, yeah.
It's going to keep me from getting it.
Yeah.
But I drink the milk.
Even if it's lumpy and yellow? And has fly larvae in it?
You didn't add that in. You said nothing about fly larvae.
Expired milk and roach legs.
That is not part of the question.
All right. So what did Bojangles say? That you would?
He said I would.
Okay, so he got that one.
The greater good of my own health, I would drink the milk.
Right. Okay. Just two more scenarios. So far, he's winning. Next scenario. Kelly twists his ankle running after a guy who looks like Ric Flair.
Yes. At the end of that question.
No. As he's being x-rayed, he overhears about the coronavirus patient being cared for just one floor above him. Will Kelly continue with his x-ray or limp his scared butt out of there? One entire floor up, far away.
Can I tell you a story that will help people answer this question happened today?
Please do.
So I work at a real estate company. I'm not a real estate agent. I'm just the marketing director. Mm-hmm. All of the real estate agents were at a training seminar today. The owner of our company, I was the only one in the office. The owner of our company, while at that seminar, got an email saying the Chamber of Commerce here in town was doing a coronavirus town hall at a restaurant. Would I go and sit there and take notes and report back to everyone tomorrow during the morning meeting?
It was just a town hall. But it had the coronavirus in the name.
People from the hospital were going to be there speaking and about the coronavirus. It was specifically about the coronavirus at a restaurant. I told her, I said, number one, I'm completely avoiding restaurants today for the time being and for the foreseeable future because a lot of people coming in and out of restaurants. And number two, there's no way I would go anywhere close to medical people or people of the medical profession right now if I didn't have to because they're coming in and out of hospitals. So I said, no, I would not go cover that town hall meeting.
And she understood. totally understood.
She actually did. She said, I totally understand. She emailed me back and said, I totally understand.
She's being polite. So, what did Bojangles say? Did he get that one right?
Bojangles in the chat.
Most of the people saying you'd get the heck out of there.
I would be gone so fast. I would break the glass on the way out of the door. I would
sound like,
and wait for the door to open.
Like a cartoon?
Yeah. It would sound just like that.
And a little puff of smoke.
All right. I can't find Bojangles in the chat.
Okay.
And I'm sure he's in there somewhere, but I don't see him.
Okay. Maybe someone can say, tell us what he said.
What he said. Tag me and we'll see.
Did
what
he get
said.
That one right? I'll give him the benefit of the doubt.
Yeah.
All right. So, final scenario. I don't even have to read it. All right.
Oh, by the way, Bojangles says he's out. So, yeah, he got it right.
Okay, good. So, congratulations. 3 out of 5, and you win. And now here's a bonus just for fun. Kelly is in the grocery store checkout line. All of his stuff is on the belt. When a guy in a surgical mask places his items next to Kelly's, the guy then begins coughing softly. It's a given that Kelly will not buy any of the groceries. That's not the question. The question is, will he return the items to the shelves or lie and say he left his wallet in the car and never return again ever? What are people saying?
Oh, boy. Okay, so experts are saying that you should only wear a mask if you have a sickness, if you have the coronavirus or have the flu. You shouldn't wear it if you don't.
Because it doesn't protect you, or does it? Or...
Right.
See, he left his wallet. Stingray said he left his wallet in the car. I mean, I do that sometimes without any virus. I'm like, oh, you know what? Gotta go. I wouldn't put the. I mean, that's rude. Kelly, what's your answer?
As soon as I see the guy in the mask, I start creeping towards the door. As soon as I hear the first syllable of the cough, I'm out the door. No time for an excuse. I'm not making excuses. I'm getting the heck out of there.
Okay, what if it's just a surgical mask? No cough.
Oh, I'm gone.
You're gone. Really?
A surgical mask is a sign that he's sick, possibly, with the coronavirus.
When I went to Washington, D.C., I was in a Maryland hotel, and there was these two girls in there with surgical masks on. This is like 2 weeks ago. Surgical masks on because they care so much about not getting sick. They care about their bodies so much. The temples, right? Well, after I checked in, I went outside and there they were lifting up their masks and smoking. So, does that make sense? Nope. My body's a temple. I can't let any carcinogens or diseases in.
Yeah.
Anyway.
So any of these 5 scenarios, would you have answered the same way as me? Or would you have been, I don't care. I'm good.
Oh, okay. Well,
Because you're not a germaphobe in any way, shape, or form.
No.
And you've got a great immune system.
I do.
And you very seldom get sick.
I do, yeah. I'm sick once every 2 years. Let's see. I would have a guest on that was positive. I would be on the, I'd be fine on the cruise ship. I'd drink the milk. I'd probably put it on cereal. I don't care about Ric Flair, but I don't know. If there's a coronavirus patient one floor above, I'd be uncomfortable probably, but I would stay. And then the grocery stuff. Yeah, I mean, I would get the heck out of there as well. I'd be gone. I'd be gone. So congratulations, man. Bojangles, you got it. Yes, sir. Now, I have a video, and then we're going to give the Master Air Screw prop prize away to a very deserving, creative video. All right? So,
yep.
I love it when kids get excited about drones. It just means a lot, and I love bestowing that excitement on our younger population. And this is from Eric, and he says, "Hey Ken, me and my family love your videos. You have inspired my daughter, Alex, who is 10, to start flying. She is trying to start her own drone channel on YouTube. Since we discovered your channel, it is pretty much the only thing that plays on our TV. It's so much more entertaining than crap on regular TV. Here's a video we made with my Mavic Mini during the kids' March break. Hope you think it's cool." And I did, and I'm going to share it. Eric, Jacob, Sam, and Alex. And so here that is. It's Mavic Mini versus the water slide. Okay. I don't know where this is, but it looks awesome and fun. It looks like maybe they would let grown-ups on it, too. Sometimes I see kit stuff like this, like ball crawl and stuff, and I just want to do it. Look at that. The only thing is, kids will run up the stairs for another one. You know, I'd be like...
Right. You'd be one and done.
Yeah. That just looks so fun.
That's awesome.
Good flying with the mini. That's a big slide, man.
Really is. I wonder if it's like one of those Great Wolf Lodge places where they have all the slides inside.
Would you go down a slide like that?
Yeah, of course. Absolutely.
Yeah. Well, you have kids to make excuses. I'd be just some weirdo that went down by himself.
Right.
Yeah. Wonderful. Thank you very much for sending that in. He also says, Alex, his daughter, would like to know if you could talk about the Tello in one of your shows. She has been flying it a lot indoors lately, as it's too cold to fly the Mini outside. Well, I did talk about the Tello. You can go back through my videos. I urge everybody to scroll back. I have many, many videos about lots of things. In fact, you can just search in Google, put my name, put Ken Heron, and then put Tello, and the video will come up. But here's a little excerpt from that as I was playing with the Mini. This is for 10-year-old Alex. Enjoy.
Stay. Thanks for watching. Thanks for subscribing.
That was Roscoe.
This is the Tello drone made by DJI and Rise. So small and so maneuverable and so awesome that you can pretty much fly it anywhere.
In a restaurant, in a small town.
What would you like today?
I think I would like the two-piece catfish, and I would like to fly my drone in your restaurant.
Oh, did Christina say you could today?
Sure.
Well, you just go for it then.
All right. I'm gonna fly over the restaurant, people. Here we go. Here comes, you guys. Oh, look at that. Now I'm gonna turn it around and come back before I get in trouble. Fly it back, here it comes.
I asked those people permission, by the way. I didn't just do it.
That's cool.
Back here to me. It's a little difficult to fly with the, but you can get a remote. And now I'm gonna land it in my hand. Here we go, and hand landing. Confirm. Okay, do it. There we go.
Hey, oh, your phone is actually the remote. Huh?
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. All right. Appreciate it. Thanks for your cooperation. Thank you. You bet. Thanks for watching. Thanks for subscribing. I hope that you continue to be happy.
Oh, Roscoe.
That's right. Happy.
You remember Roscoe?
Yeah, he's up in, what, Pennsylvania now? Didn't he get adopted by somebody?
Yeah, Massachusetts.
That was a dog that was hanging around the radio station and was severely abused by its owner who lived close to the radio station. And mm-hmm. Ken kind of took the dog under his wing and made sure it found a good home.
Yeah, I was a foster dog dad for a while for Roscoe. Roscoe was large, and I was living in a smaller house at the time. Henry loved him. They hung out. They were buddies. It was hard to give him up. But boy, he would drink so sloppily. I'd have to mop every time. Just Just an awesome dog. But he's in Massachusetts now with his new owner. Yeah. But there you go, Alex. Have fun with your future droning.
Oh, Bojangles, thanks for the $2 super sticker.
Hey, thanks, Bojangles. And Jolly Roger. Yo-yo. Love your channel, and you have taught me a lot. Thanks. Wonderful. And we got a couple more. Ten Toes. Hey, Ten Toes. Ack, drone germs. Now, I don't know if Ten Toes would be worried about germs because dude never wears shoes. Yeah, I met him at Spin Up this last year, and barefoot. Yep. A pure heifer with a $2 super sticker, fist bump, and Jerry, thumbs up from Jerry. Thanks, man. All right. So we have another contest here in just a little bit, but I do want to remind everybody to check out those Master Air Screw props, baby. MasterAirScrew.com. They've got a great thing happening. Let me show you their website here. Master Air Screw propellers are very well made propellers. They're a lot quieter than OEMs. They have them for all kinds of drones and other RCs like fixed wing aircraft, all kinds of things. I mean, there's so many colors and options, and they got fiberglass and they got carbon fiber, and they're very well made, these things.
Yeah, they give you a little more flight time, they give you a little more power, and like you said, they come in super cool colors, and they look so sporty.
They do, and we have a special discount code that you can enjoy right now, and that is TNL2YM3. Kelly, can you confirm on that?
TNL2YM3, I can confirm that.
All right. And so what we're going to do now is going to make these available to someone. Giving out props every week, giving props to someone who submits a creative video. And you can do that right here, kenheronupload@gmail.com. If you made a video that's clever or innovative in some way, then please do that. This one this week goes to, and thank you for putting the pronunciation key, John Zangline. Believe me, it doesn't look like Zangline, but he included a key there. He says, "Hey Ken, I have a video for you. It shows what happens when you put a Mavic Mini into Sentry mode. It features the atrium of an old manufacturing building where the drone chase took place. I hope you can use it on TNL. Have a good day, John Zangline," as in old Zang line, I guess. All right, so thank you very much to him and Master Air Screws. Props of the week. Enjoy.
Oh no!
That's awesome.
Very dramatic.
Yeah.
Wonderful. That is awesome. Thank you so much for sending that in. And you win the Master Airscrew propellers for the props of the week.
MasterAirscrew.com.
MasterAirscrew.com. And the special secret code gets you, I think it's 10% off. Is that right?
Yep. TNL2YM3. And save yourself some money and get these things.
Master Airscrew. Love you. Mean it. All right.
Hey, thanks, Geeks Vana, for the 3-pound super sticker.
Oh, yeah. Hey, Geeks Vana, man. He watches all the time. It's like, let's see what time. Alexa, what time is it in London?
In London, it's 1:54 a.m.
Is there any live stream that you would stay up that late for, Kelly?
Ric Flair.
Okay.
With one-on-one.
Anyway, thank you, Geeks Vana. Corona, pound. There we go.
Yeah. Cairo, $10. You and Gray Hughes Investigates got me into drones. Thanks for that.
Oh, you're welcome. Awesome. Man, that, I really appreciate the support. It means a lot. I'm doing this full time now. And, you know, it's kind of rough sometimes. Am I
gonna
be
going for you? Are you behind on your rent yet?
Not yet.
Are they going to repo your car?
Not yet. No, I have plenty of plasma, and I have two kidneys.
Okay.
Down to, I'm selling it by the half. Did you know you can sell them by the half? So I got one and a half.
You sell a half?
You sell a half one. Yeah. Okay. So what do you say we try to do this? It could blow up the stream, but let's try to do a little constructive criticism.
Okay.
All right. Now, I invite people to put a link to a video in the description now, and I'll let Kelly pick someone, and we will give some constructive criticism on your video.
So you'll click the link, you'll watch one of their videos, and you'll give some constructive criticism on what they're flying, their editing, their selection of music, a little bit of everything.
Whatever you guys want, just, you know, copy and paste the link in the chat. Maybe put, you know, what do you think of my piloting, or, you know, what do you think of the color grading or whatever?
All right, good idea.
Yeah, and then I'll play a little bit of it, and we'll go through it and talk about it. Give you some helpful tips. Oh wait, hold on. Oh, there's it. Here. We'll give you some helpful tips. All right. So who do we got? Anybody?
I don't know. You want to go with Anubis Arts, TJ Grady? He's a loyal viewer of the show every week. Or the Mike Roche, who I've destroyed in 1 second song before. I embarrassed him. I can't believe he came back.
Oh, man. And by the way, I know you can hear the train. Tonight, there is a mystery challenger going head to head with Kelly Green for 1 second song. Coming up in just a little bit. You want to talk some smack to this person who you don't know it is yet?
Let's lay some odds here, Ken. You know this guy. I don't know this guy or girl.
Yeah.
What are the odds this person has a chance against the man?
I don't know, but isn't it something about in order to be the man, you have to beat the man or some garbage like that?
And I'm the man, so if they want to step up, they can bring it.
All right. So we got, Metro Drones. Let's check out one from him. Let's see here. And did it do it properly? I think it did. Okay, so we do there, and then we click that, and then we do this, and then we maximize this screen. Oh, there we go. So this is the Oakland County International Airport. Okay, already I'm seeing problems. That's the tower. I don't think Lance is going to give you permission to, or maybe it's a museum. Could it be a museum?
I don't know, man.
Let's assume
he's got all the legal issues out of the way.
Yes. Okay. This is a fine shot of the plane here.
Nice orbit.
It's a nice orbit, and you can see in the shadow that it was an Inspire. It could be a museum. It would be good to have that information, because people like us are like, you fly around a tower. So this video is about 3 minutes long, which is not too terribly long for something like this. I think maybe some more information. People generally prefer, would you agree, Kelly, that people generally prefer narration over printed words in a video? Would you agree with that?
Yeah, if you have time to do that, they do. A lot of times in my job, I don't have time to do that, so I throw the graphics on the screen.
Right. And people very often don't take into consideration how important the music is. They just have music there just to have it. This music, not to be super critical, but it just doesn't seem to fit. Maybe something, since you're showing period planes, something along in that period of the music, perhaps, might add a little bit of something to it. I like
that. And in the opening shot, we had the control tower. The control tower is kind of the focal point of that scene, so I would have moved the graphics of the text down to the bottom of the screen.
Right, and you can also, in order to set the scene, have a shot like this maybe in the beginning where it shows the entire scene. You don't always, when you're orbiting something, you don't always have to have it centered exactly in the middle. The eye will naturally be drawn towards the object, but you want to include its surrounding as well. You don't want to force anyone really to look at any one thing. But I do like that the orbits are nice and slow and not super fast and spinny. It's got a nice wide selection of various planes. And it's just about over. It would have been nice to include some handheld footage or some tripod footage. Mm-hmm. And again, a little bit of narration. But look at that. An AMA group. Now that's awesome. Awesome. Thank you, Metro Drones, for sharing that. Your final thoughts on that, Kelly?
Yeah, I mean, everybody's got room for improvement. I've got no room to talk because, man, oh, man, if Ken's an A+, I'm a C-.
Right,
maybe
well,
a few too... What?
Maybe a few too many what?
Maybe a few too many orbits, like you said. Mix it up a little bit. Give me some ground footage. Just give me a few different types of shots to mix it all together. And
if you're telling a story, yes, if you're telling a story, get some close-ups and then maybe back it wider. You know, we want to see more detail in the plane. Remember, you're telling a story to those who know nothing about it. So, yeah, but we each have our own way of presenting art. But
I like this segment. Good segment.
Oh, thanks. You want to do one more?
We got time?
Nope. All right, so okay. Moving on. No, actually, you know what? If you want to submit, we can do this next week as well, but if you want to send something for constructive criticism, you can send it here, kenheronupload@gmail.com. Also, if you just have a cool video you want to share, please do that. If you have news stories, people send me news stories about drones all the time, send it directly to our newsroom, tnlnewsleads@gmail.com. That goes right to Jeff's hot little sweaty hands.
Mm, yeah. They are very sweaty.
So sweaty. All right.
Never shake his hand.
So I have to blow my nose, and I'm not going to do that in front of people, so I'm going to do this, and then I'm going to mute my microphone while Kelly tells us a joke while I snot it up.
All right. Why did the cowboy buy one of those wiener dogs? Why, Kelly? He wanted to get along, little doggy.
Wow. Yes, and I know you can hear my air conditioner. Should I turn it off? I'll turn it off. It makes a huge difference. It's an in-wall. I don't have central air here. That's how old the house is. Watch.
Oh.
And it's quiet. TJ Grady with a $10 super chat. Thanks, man. Ken, this is a great segment of the show. Love it. Keep it going. Yeah, we I'll probably allow more time next week to do like even two or three of them. That would be fun. I hope we gave Metro Drones some constructive criticism.
Yeah, I think next time I'll just shut up. I don't know if I'm qualified to give any constructive criticism on flying a drone.
Of course you are. Now, we're going to do 1 second song in here in just a minute. But first, a video from Thomas. Hello, Ken. I bought my first drone, a Mavic Mini, in January and quickly discovered your YouTube channel. I've been happily working my way through your video catalog ever since. Thanks. I really appreciate the unbridled fun and insightful experience you put into your work. You've been an inspiration. Here is a short video I shot with the Mini and one of the first I've edited together. The subject is the Fruin Mill in Minneapolis, Minnesota, abandoned since 1971. Thanks for doing what you do, and I hope you enjoy the video. And that's from Thomas. Here is the Fruin Mill. FPV guys would call this a bando. Short for abandoned.
Wow.
abandoned stuff is really fun to film with a drone, especially those really high grain silos. Or those are cement, I think. That's cement.
Is that really short for abandoned if it has the exact same amount of syllables?
Bando?
Oh, I thought you said a bando.
Oh, no, no, no. It's bando.
Gotcha.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, no, they put a lot of thought into that word.
I see. I'm sure they do.
But I'm too old to say it, I think. Awesome. Thanks, man.
Love
it. That was a short little one from Thomas. Thanks, Thomas. All right. Now, all that's left is the viewer video of the week, and it's wonderful. And but right now, it's our new segment called the FPV MVP. And the winner will get Freewell filters from freewellgear.com. And the winner this week is... Tom's FPV. That's T-O-M-Z FPV. There's a link in the description. If FPV through bandos makes you sick, motion sickness, look away for just about 2 minutes. But for the rest of us, this is astonishingly talented piloting. Enjoy. Amazing.
Wow.
I could only hope to FPV like this one though. Just find those tiny holes. You have no desire to fly like this, Kelly?
I really don't. I just don't have any notion to do it.
Is that because sometimes when you're flying, this can happen? Stop. Oh, yeah. Oh. What a great location. I just find this fascinating. Such an adrenaline rush, man.
Yeah. I mean, I respect these pilots so much because I know I can never do it. So I'm just going to leave it to them and I'll enjoy their footage.
Thought he was going to go in, right?
Yeah.
No. See, this is the kind of stuff that FPV people look at and go, oh my God.
Wow.
Look at all the tiny holes. I could watch literally hours of this. Wow. A lot of it's luck, you know?
Really? A lot of it is luck?
Oh, it has to be. You know, there's... You watch videos like this, they're editing out a lot of crashes. Yeah. These are rugged little drones, man. So many broken propellers. What a wonderful time we're living in, man. Oh, I just love it. If I could fly 1/10 of as good as this dude.
Ah, oh, that's next level stuff.
Right? Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, 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 yeah. That is our FPV.
Go ahead.
Yeah, that's our FPV MVP this week. If you want to be a FPV MVP and possibly win Freewell ND filters, send yours in. KenHearnUpload@gmail.com. What were you saying, Kelly?
It's got to feel like a video game at times, right? I mean, doing that, it's just
right.
It's so
I mean,
fast. It's so furious.
That's, you know, that's why I think a lot of younger people do it because they're used to that
yeah.
environment. But, yep. Hopefully I'm not too old. So now it's time for 1 second song. All right. So we need people right now to say, pick me, pick me, pick me, pick me. We're going to pick two contestants. One that will win if Kelly wins, and one that will win if our mystery challenger wins. All right? And the winner has their choice of Mavic Mini Do-It-Yourself Creative Kit. These are the stickers that go on the Mavic Mini that decorate them, and you can, it comes with a marker set. You can make your own art. Or a set of Master Air Screw props. Or if you don't have any of those, you can also get a whole bunch of eyeballs. So pick me, pick me.
Am I picking both contestants?
Yes. You pick one for you, one for our mystery challenger, who we will call here in just a moment.
All right. Got it.
All right. Who is Kelly playing for?
I am playing for Harry Bryant.
All right. And who is our mystery challenger playing for?
Kay Cadby.
All right.
Kay Cadby.
Very good. 1 second song.
It's a song. It's a song. It's a 1 second song. So it's way too short for you to try to sing along. It's a song. It's a song. It's a 1 second song. Take a guess and see if you're right or wrong. It's a song. It's a song. It's a 1 second song. You can win a prize made in Hong Kong.
All right. Now, here is Kelly with a joke as I bring in our mystery challenger.
Can I guess who it is before you bring him in? Or would you rather have the joke?
I'd rather have the joke.
All right, the joke is, why can't you hear a pterodactyl go to the bathroom?
Why?
This is for the good spellers out there. Why can't you hear a pterodactyl go to the bathroom?
Why?
Because the P is silent.
Meh. Wah, wah, wah. Oh, wah, 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 wah. All right. Bringing in our contestant. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome
Ashley.
Ashley. Hey, everybody, it's Ashley. Kelly, you there, buddy?
Can Kelly, you hear me?
Kelly gone. Oh, there he is. Okay, he's back. You blipped out for a second. So, Ashley is back. Now
I'm back, baby.
Please,
I'm back.
Why are you freezing, Kelly? Why are you freezing up on me?
I'm cold.
turn your camera off and then back on.
He can't handle it, Ken.
Oh,
he saw me come in. He got nervous.
Ooh. Oh. Mm. All right. Well, I'm gonna have to call Kelly back because.
He already chickened out. He don't even wanna. He don't even wanna redo. He don't wanna rematch. He knows.
He knows what's up. So last time, you and this has been going on for a while. We used to play this on the radio, and this is the first time ever that you beat him the last time you guys played together.
Ever. In almost any game, I'm pretty sure. Ever.
Yeah. Okay, is Kelly back? Is Kelly back? Is this going to work? All right, good. Kelly?
Cool.
Are you ready?
This is the rematch to end all rematches. It's Loser Leaves Town. The winner will be forever crowned the 1 second song champion. After this, there will never be another rematch. So, Ashley, don't sing it. Bring it.
Ooh! Ashley, you gonna take that? You gonna take that, girl?
Listen, I've been riding that high since I won last time. I was just talking about how I never beat you at a game, not even on the radio, but that one time, I've been riding that high. Let me tell you, I went to work the next day telling everybody. They don't know who you are.
Everybody.
Why? Because I'm the champion.
Everybody.
I'm the champion.
Hoo, hoo, hoo. She is wearing the belt right now. She is the defending champion.
Yeah.
Sorry to say. And right, by the way,
right now, she is the man.
Thank you, Tennessee Rocky Raccoon with a $5 super chat. Great show, guys. Welcome back, 1 second song champ. All right. Now,
Is this one of those generational things? Or is it going to be straight up 1 second song?
There are some songs that she will know more, and there are some songs that you will know more. I tried to even it out. Okay?
I want to know in the chat who you think's going to win right off the bat.
Me, duh.
Now, for those who are new to the stream, we play this game to try to kind of outwit the YouTube algorithm, because if you play too much of a song, they go, naughty, you can't do that. But if we play 1 second of it, right?
We're good.
We're good. So before we begin, I am going to test you guys. I have a song that Ashley should absolutely know, but probably doesn't. And I have a song for you, Kelly, that you should absolutely know, but probably don't, for different reasons.
So are we rotating or are we ringing
this,
in?
This isn't the game. This is just a precursor.
It's the warm-up round,
Kelly. It's the warm-up. So, if I can find it, where is it? Oh, yeah. Okay. So, Ashley?
Yes.
What movie is this from?
What?
Everybody in the don't read the chat now, Ashley. Turn off your chat. Both of you turn off your chat. Okay.
I have Skype open my computer.
Okay. So everybody in the chat knows, Ashley.
And that is from the movie The Great Gatsby.
That's a good guess.
Yeah? No, that's wrong. Kelly? What movie is that from?
I'm not a big sci-fi fan, but I do know a William Shatner movie when I hear one. That is from Star Trek.
You just did that on purpose just to piss everybody off. That's
in your face.
That's from Star Wars. That's the Cantina song. All right? Now, for you, Mr. Wise Guy, you should know this, but probably don't. What is the name of this song?
Is that
All right.
I have no idea.
Just name the group.
Def Leppard.
Duran Duran.
What? That is not Duran Duran.
Yes, it is.
Play it again.
That is Astronaut from their 2004 release.
You know their career was over by 1993.
Yeah, but you're the world's biggest Duran Duran fan. Mm. Ooh, all right, all right.
They had already lost two members by then. They were Duran Duran.
I burned both of you. All right, so let's begin with this one. 1 second song.
So, are we rotating or ringing in?
Ringing in. Use your name as your buzzer. Okay?
Oh, I hate this. I should have known. Right, Ashley!
Yes, Ashley. Yes.
Ashley, that's Billie Eilish. Oh. And I'm going to guess that it's Everything I Wanted.
Kelly?
Yes, Kelly.
Billie Eilish, Bad Guy?
No.
Something like that.
No. Wow. You both got it wrong. That's No Time to Die. That's from the new
James Bond movie.
James Bond movie, yeah. Anybody in the chat get that? They all got that it was Billie Eilish. Because she... All right.
Man! I'm so mad at me.
Yes or no, is Billie Eilish talented?
Well, she got like 11 Grammys, so somebody thinks she is. She is, yes. I think she is, yes. I'll go with it.
Okay.
And she's got green hair. It's kind of cool. Green's my favorite color. All right. So, remember to ring in with your name.
Okay.
1 second song.
Kelly.
Yes, Kelly.
Chumba Wumba Tub Thumping.
That is not real.
He totally got it from this.
That's a chord that's in millions of songs.
Have you heard that Ashley? Song before, Ashley?
I've never even heard the words he just said. I don't even know.
You've heard that.
Oh, I didn't know that one.
All right.
Just remember, to be the man, you got to beat the man. And if you want to be the man like this jet flying, limousine riding, kiss stealing, wheeling dealing, son of a gun, you will never be the man.
Lord E. Lord.
Wow.
All right. Here is... Here's the next 1 second song. Now, some of these are a little bit more than 1 second. Just go with it. Here's the next one.
And I got no plans to retire.
Ashley.
Yes, Ashley.
Eminem.
And I got no plans to retire.
Oh, no.
Kelly.
Yes, Kelly.
Eminem. Music to be murdered by.
No, you're both wrong. That is a Juice World or something. It's got Godzilla. Godzilla. That's the name of the song.
Oh.
Just a bunch of crap.
Wow.
okay. Here is the next 1 second song. Hey,
hey! Kelly.
Yes, Kelly.
No.
It's Def Leppard.
Hey, hey! People in the chat are getting it. Wow.
Baba. Hey, hey! Ashley, I saw you peeking at the chat, so don't be
Don't you cheat, girl. Don't you cheat.
No cheating.
Hey, hey! I don't know the title. Is it four, three, two, one? It's either Animal or Pour Some Sugar on Me.
Pour Some Sugar on Me. Should have gone with it.
Did I get to-
You didn't know that, actually. Stop fronting.
Right. Stop fronting.
And hey, look, if you're going to front, I will not tolerate any fronting.
I
won't have it. I've had it up to here with your fronting. Yo.
All right. All right. Here is the next 1 second song.
Echoed voices.
Name is your buzzer.
Kelly.
Yes, Kelly.
The Eagles' Witchy Woman.
Whoa! What's the score, by the way?
Stand by while I tabulate it.
Okay. Oh. Ashley.
Are you that bad at math?
Have you ever heard any music before, Ashley?
Listen to me when I tell you.
Yeah.
Not old music. You guys are outdated.
Hey, I'm playing Eminem and all this new stuff. You got nothing, girl. All right. Mm-hmm. All right, here's the next Here's the next 1 second song. Name is your buzzer.
I'm yours.
No.
I'm yours.
People in the chat are throwing shade.
One more time. Ashley?
Yes, Ashley.
I feel like it's Harry Styles. And it's his new single.
Kelly.
Yes, Kelly.
Harry Styles, Adore.
You're both wrong. That's the Jonas Brothers, What a Man Gotta Do.
That song. I hate me.
Okay. All right, we're running out of songs now. Just a few more.
Oh, man.
Ashley's not even on the board.
I'm nervous.
Title reign is coming to an end tonight.
Not even on the board. The board. Boy, this microphone sounds great, doesn't it?
That's good.
The board.
All
right.
No.
All right. Here's the. I lost myself for a minute. I'm back. Here is the next 1 second song.
Ashley!
Yes, Ashley.
That's Dolly Parton 9 to 5.
Yes! She's on the board. Oh my gosh.
I'm on the board.
You can see that. It started here and it was Ashley! Ashley's on the board.
My name for a second.
Ben Cartwright says 9-6.
So close.
Missed it by that much. All right. Ashley, I'm confident that you will get this one, as I picked it specifically to help you.
This seems very one-sided. The song selection seems so one-sided.
I picked Chumbawamba, dude. That was a gimme. All right?
The Eagles?
Yeah. All right. Here's the next one. Listen carefully. 1 second song.
In my toes, curl, yeah, yeah.
Oh, Ashley!
Yeah.
Ashley!
Yeah. 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 Yes, Ashley.
Justin Bieber? Yummy.
Yes!
Yeah, you catch me.
Hold on, I need something. This song
in my toes curl, yeah, yeah.
Is a piece of and it's a piece that has what? Like a half a billion views.
I know. Have you seen the video?
Yes. He almost grew that mustache. Almost, it's almost there. Hey, look,
I'm not trying to make excuses, but we've got Justin Bieber, we've got Billie Eilish, we've got Dolly Parton, we've got Eminem, and we've gotten the Jonas Brothers, and we've gotten the Eagles, and we've gotten Chumbawamba. Do you notice a pattern here? Kelly songs, Ashley songs.
Excuse me, sir.
That's by design.
Okay,
you
gotcha.
You have a teenage daughter, so you should know Billie Eilish, okay? So don't come for me like that.
Yeah.
No, sir, you've been alive longer than me.
Dolly Parton? Kelly, Dolly Parton, you were deer in the headlights. Where were you on that, country man? That was for you.
I'm not making excuses. I'm about to give you some results. So here we go.
Oh, okay.
All right. Just a couple more. Here's the next one. 1 second song. Name is your buzzer.
I love mine.
Yes, Ashley?
Stand by your man?
Ooh, chance to steal, Kelly.
I love mine.
Come on, Kelly.
I have no idea.
Thought you were going to get it back.
Well, I'm a little bit country, and he's a little bit rock and roll.
Donnie and Marie?
Dude, oh my God, no. What's the score, man?
Still tied at 2-2.
Oh, still tied.
Yeah!
All right. There's only two more.
Oh, dear. You got to figure they're both Ashley songs.
Mm-mm. One of each. One of each.
Just be a loser.
Here we go. Name this song.
I hang up the phone, you call me back. I hang up the phone, you call me back.
The song is charting now.
Now?
I hang up the phone, you call me back.
Anybody got it in the chat?
No.
Give us the artist and I'll give you the title.
All right, tell you what. I'll give you the artist. Use your name as your buzzer before you give me the title. Okay? All right.
Yep.
Pussycat Dolls.
No idea.
They're back on the charts?
Oh! It's called React. Ugh. Which neither of you did.
Nobody in the chat got that.
They're no. real charting again, though? For real?
I think so.
Oh, that's all right. Awful. We need to... Mm-mm.
Last...
It's all going to come down to this one.
Last one. This is it. Last... 1 second song for all the marbles. It's tied. Bases loaded. Some other sports analogy I'm not familiar with. You ready?
Mm-hmm.
Here it is.
Ooh, Ali.
Ashley.
Yes, Ashley.
It's Elvis. And it's
Kelly.
It's no Kelly, don't interrupt me. It's Elvis and it's
Ooh, Ali.
Kelly.
Sorry, Ashley. Chance for all the marbles. Kelly?
I think It's Tiny Bubbles.
Oh, no! Wow, man, he got it. He is back. Ladies and gentlemen. Yeah. Oh, and now here is Ashley with her concession speech.
Kelly, I just want to say you're an okay opponent. I'm glad that you had the opportunity to see me again. I'm going to beat you at another game eventually. It's going to be a sneak attack. You're not going to be ready. And you were supposed to take it easy on me. My Reba concert got postponed.
Oh.
Oh, did you have tickets to Reba and it got canceled?
Yeah, for next Saturday, Kelly. I've been looking forward to this for 3 months. Anyways, so you were supposed to be nice to me.
Well, I tell you what. How about this? How about if I'm nice to you, Ashley?
Yeah?
Yeah.
I don't trust you.
As we head into the Hawaiian Lounge.
He's gonna sing.
Ladies and gentlemen. Ken Ho.
So ready.
Tiny bubbles.
Wow.
In the wine. Make me happy. Make me feel fine. Tiny bubbles make me warm all over with the feeling that I'm gonna love you till the end of time. So here's to the golden moon, and here's to the silver sea. And mostly, here's a toast to you and me. Tiny bubbles,
tiny bubbles.
In the wine,
in the wine.
Make me happy,
makes me happy.
Makes me feel fine,
makes me feel fine.
Those tiny bubbles,
tiny bubbles,
makes me warm all over with a feeling that I'm gonna love you till the end of time.
Tiny bubbles.
Ooh, a licky
in the wine.
Ica my life. Oh, ha, oh, he
makes me feel fine.
Ik ba'al il nu, those tiny bubbles. Makes me warm all over with a feeling that I'm gonna love you till the end of time. With the feeling that I'm gonna love you, gonna love you till the end of time.
Thanks for coming out. Tip your bartender and your waitress. Try the veal. Good night.
That was beautiful. Wow.
Very nice.
That was great.
Did you enjoy that? Did that make you happy, Ashley? Thank you.
That was great.
Thanks. I appreciate that.
Well, I mean, I still lost the game, but
it did.
There ain't going to be no rematch. I'll tell you that right now.
Oh! He did sound like Elvis, didn't he? Don Ho? Yeah.
Don Ho, right. Yeah.
All right, Ashley.
Huh.
Well, I guess that's it. The title has gone back to what I dare say is the rightful owner.
Oh, can't take it back.
Oh, no, you're right. I have to be impartial. I have to be impartial. But I tell you, it was impossible to hang around Kelly when you had the title. We'd be just driving
really?
In the car and he'd burst out into tears. Yeah. It was a sad, sad thing. I'd have to hold him and rock him. It was a bad thing.
Ashley, Go tuck yourself into your bed there behind you and dream how you're never going to beat me again.
Oh! All right, Ashley, thank you so much for being on.
Yeah, anytime.
Okay, love you, mean it. Bye.
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 Gotta love that, Ashley.
You know what I thought it was going to be? I thought it was going to be Dana Williams. I thought he's pulling Dana Williams out of a hat tonight, and he's going to take me on in 1 second song.
Oh, you thought? Really?
That's what I thought.
He'll be back one day. Robert Hip, thank you very much for the $2 super chat. A tip for Ken Law. You know it's hip to be Robert.
That's so what
Huey,
I hear.
Huey Lewis told me.
Oh, Max Air 420, $2. Thank you, Kelly. Game over, Ash. Bye.
Bye.
All right, let me see. Show's going a little long tonight. There's something else. There's something else I wanted to share, but no, not that. Well, I guess that's it. We're going to do the viewer video of the week. And tonight, the winner of the freewellgear.com filters is... Brett Harvey. Congrats, Brett. He writes, hey, Ken, I think I heard somewhere that you like erosion in rocks. You heard right. I mean, you go anywhere and people will tell you Ken is a huge erosion fan.
Is he ever?
Wouldn't that be a great name for a 70s progressive rock band?
Ladies erosion. And gentlemen, one night only, Erosion.
There's a band somewhere called Erosion in there.
Gotta be.
Based on this, I thought you might enjoy my latest video. Regards, Brett Harvey. It's the viewer video of the week. Here it is. Enjoy. This is a beach in Australia. Australia is a beautiful place. Greg Kuhnert wants me to come visit. But there's too many drop bears and killer jellyfish and... I mean, they're trying to kill Tom Hanks. I don't know if I'd do well down there right now.
Yeah, may want to wait at least, give it a good 6 months and then go.
Yeah. If only COVID-19 killed Australian spiders instead of humans. But look at that. My goodness.
Beautiful.
Wonderful.
Nice.
That's beautiful. Thank you so much for sending that in. If you want to send in a video for a viewer video of the week or anything, if you just think it's cool, kenheronupload@gmail.com. If you want to send me something in the snail mail, and I haven't gotten anything lately, Ken Heron, Box 1281, Huntingdon, Tennessee, 38344. There you go.
By the way, people in the chat are clamoring for the one thing you forgot tonight.
What could that be?
Let's step into the Raz Chamber.
Yes.
We've been sort of razzing it up all night, but yes. Really, we need full-blown Raz. I initially had several Raz symptoms, but now it's blossomed into full-blown Raz. Everyone is safe in the Raz. The Raz is the only known cure for the coronavirus.
Really?
Nope. But it is pretty, isn't it?
Sure enough. Don't do what I think you're about to do. Ah, knew it!
No farting in the Raz, please. No farting in the Raz. So, Kelly!
Yes.
Now is the time when you can pimp your Instagram. Yeah. How many followers do you have?
912.
You do, really?
Yes.
Oh, that's great. They even get you up over 1,000.
Yeah, I need that.
Yeah. If you want to join my Instagram, follow me as well. There's a link in the description. I think it's just ken.heron.
But, how many followers you have?
I think 3,000 maybe or something.
Yeah, hate you.
Does that mean I'm more betterer?
You're more of an influencer than I am.
Yeah. Anyway, thank you very much for everybody who has supported the channel all along. I see so many familiar names in the chat. We go back later and watch it and read all the chats that we missed. So if you have any suggestions for guests in the future, you can also send your guest suggestions to kenheronupload@gmail.com. I will be hitting the road in the spring. Hopefully things have calmed down in the viral world by then, but I'm still going to head out on the road and hopefully meet a lot of you along the way. Me and my little co-pilot Henry will be heading out. Where should I go first, Kelly? Just go up north and go down that way? I wanted to go down Route 66 maybe.
Oh yeah, okay.
Yeah. Just me and my little...
Go up there like that.
I'll go up there like that and then make a left and go down around here like that, over there like that. Anyway, I guess that's it for today.
We hope you enjoyed the show half as much as you would have if it had been twice as good.
Thank you so much to everybody for all your super chats, super stickers, and just being super. Love you guys. Mean it. Zen Lee, who got jacked at gunpoint. His stuff stolen, still keeping a positive outlook. We thank him for taking time to speak with us tonight. Thanks to our mystery challenger, who turned out to be Adla. Thank you, Adla. And all of our sponsors. Thank you so much for supporting the show. RemotePilot101.com, LoomCube, GPC Custom Cases, Master Airscrew, FreewellGear.com, and of course, Pigeon Jerky. Until next week, thanks for watching. Thanks for subscribing. Above.
And bye.
enjoy pigeons are king. Pigeons are king. The killer the cross is me.
Say ah.
Enjoy pigeons are king. Pigeons are king. And you give your family a treat. Establish nutrition to help them grow. And it's full of fiber to make them grow. You enjoy pigeons are king.
That was so funny.